wrestlers lab, and welcome to the Mecca of Independent Wrestling, the Ridgefield Park Knights of Columbus, here in beautiful New Jersey. How do we feel, everybody? Well, the Labradors have spoken. I want to go over just a few sponsors, because like any good experiment, we have some mysterious benefactors that should be mentioned. Broken Optics. First off, thank you to Broken Optics, Curtain Jerker, Fight Boys, JCP Designs, Smart NATO. Smart NATO brought us delicious pizza today, so he gets a little extra love. The TMNT Universe, and of course, Mesa Media. Here at Wrestlers Lab, they are building an environment and progressing the sport of professional wrestling, building a better environment for not just the talent, for the fans, an all-inclusionary atmosphere that is pushing the progression of this very sport. So we thank Wrestlers Lab right off the bat. But we can't give them too much credit because they ask you to bring weapons for 10 people to kick the crap out of each other, so there's still a lot of work to be done. We are going to start things off right away with a singles match that is scheduled for one fall. Joining us at this time, she is sponsored by Women's Wrestling Watch. That's at www.anyho. Please welcome official Rosie Jones. And this match will be your first match, a singles match, single for one fall.
Hello, Labradors. And welcome to Wrestlers Lab Showabunga 2. Here we are at the hub of East Coast independent wrestling at the Mecca. I'm Toddy Tondera.
And I'm Darnell Mitchell, the fabulous fashionista of New York City.
A lot better than I am today. Welcome to the commentary table. What's on the docket for you, Darnell?
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to return to Wrestlers Lab. I'm so excited to have you here at Wrestlers Lab.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome. Welcome. And you look amazing, by the way.
Thank you. One of the original Labradors. Welcome back to the lab, Darnell Mitchell.
Thank you. Thank you. It's going to be an amazing, amazing show tonight. The fans are riled up. This is going to be incredible.
Time to get a little wacky, Darnell.
The one and only Erica Lee.
Now, Erica Lee was undefeated at Wrestlers Lab until the bad brain Eel O'Neill was victorious over Erica Lee back at 7 Years of Science in Pittsburgh. So Erica Lee has shown up to Showabunga 2 just like she showed up to Showabunga 1 and is looking for a big victory, trying to get her mojo back.
Yeah, she's got a little bit of a chip on her shoulder, and she's come here with a little bit more determination. You can kind of see it in her eyes. She's ready to defend that loss.
And accolades for Erica Lee. She was the first woman in the men's Super 8 tournament. She won the women's Super 8 tournament, defeating Jordan Blade. First woman to hold the ECWA legacy title, and she's big. A little gnome on gnome action to start things off. Look at that gnome. A gnome presentation.
Yeah, Erica, hopefully this is coming from a good place.
Seems like it. All's fair, love and war.
Now, don't forget, Gabby's actually making her debut here at Wrestlers Lab. So exciting to see her. She's a little bit newer to the wrestling scene, but I've seen some incredible stuff from her. So I think she's going to put Erica to the test tonight.
Yeah, Gabby trained at Creative Pro Wrestling in Long Island. She's a two-time national linebacker, number 56. And here we go. Opponents recently of Gabby Forza, Chris Statlander, Masha Slamovich, Brian Myers.
We can already see here, too. Keep in mind, Erica's definitely going to have to work really, really fast because Gabby definitely has a strength advantage.
But they call Erica Lee the big gal for a reason. She's very big, very technical. She faced off against Bonesaw Brooks at Showabunga 1. We will see if Erica's reminiscent of Showabunga 1 and her intensity and headlock takeover down. Spinning around a little bit. Out the cover. Two.
Ooh, a two count already that early.
And as you mentioned, Darnell, in the chemistry today, we have new elements in the mix, like a Gabby Forza, like Creeps, Trey Shaw, Eli Hush. This is my first time at the Mecca myself. Lock it up there. Test his strength here. Tell you what, I wouldn't want to be in the ring with either of these competitors, but especially with a linebacker.
Exactly, exactly. Erica's got to make sure that she uses her little bit of her wits here. Doesn't want to go one-on-one strength-wise with Gabby.
Yeah. Looks like Erica Lee got the wind knocked out of her. Oh, flipping through here. Oh! Tell you what, once that bell rang, that gnome presentation was off the table. These two want to win.
Yeah. Gabby's got to keep on her.
Oh!
Honestly, I felt that one.
Yeah. Darnell, I'm glad that you and I are over here and not in there. Oh, sunset flip. Two. Oh, just a two count.
Yeah, that was a veteran. Look at the way that she actually locked her legs in. Yeah. She made sure the shoulders were down.
Oh, things are getting serious now. This would be quite the victory for Gabby Forza in her debut. Erica Lee again, as I mentioned before, undefeated until she went one-on-one with Eel O'Neill for that Wrestlers Lab championship. Crowd wants one more time. You can't get Gabby Forza over. It's a powerful base. Strength in the hips. I think Gabby said, come on,
yeah.
See that? Finally. Oh, trying to pick up.
Oh.
Throwing against the turnbuckle there.
That's nice work by Gabby. She's been working on that midsection. That's going to hinder a lot of Erica's moves coming up.
Down. Two.
Very strong lateral press there.
And you usually see from Gabby Forza that infectious personality. But right now, it's all serious business in there with a lab veteran like Erica Lee.
Exactly. Well, I mean, you're facing off against someone who, again, who has only been defeated once here at Wrestlers Lab.
One
and
time.
You're making your debut.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Oh, big clothesline again there. Test of strength from both these competitors in the ring. They want to show they are the stronger of the two. So Erica Lee held that ECWA Unified Heavyweight title. So accolades all around, but right now a big power slam down to the canvas here. Oh, big Vader.
Incredible.
Vader bomb of sorts. And this crowd, Darnell, is behind Gabby.
Absolutely. It's a little surprising here. Erica usually has the fans really, really behind her. And Erica's kind of taking a beating here.
There's no homie like the Nomi, as they say.
Oh! Nothing but adrenaline there.
Yeah, I was going to say, Darnell, it seems like the only thing Erica had left, she just unleashed it. There we go. Erica trying to fight back. If she's able to switch into that next gear, Gabby may be in trouble. We shall see, just pounding on the chest. Oh, big boot. knee. Wow, spin kick. She got her leg way up there, Darnell.
Erica's getting the momentum, and she's got to stay on her, though. She's been taking a beating a little bit on this match. Keep on her. Use those veteran wiles.
Of course, Erica Lee, one half of Gummy Boar. Coming up, Gummy Boar has an Enjoy Tag Team Championship match against the Production. Oh, wow.
With ease.
Oh, big fallaway slam over the back. The power of the linebacker, Gabby Forza. Oh, maybe I've telegraphed that one a little bit too much, Darnell. Dumped on the outside. Oh, she caught herself.
Back up very quickly.
Into the second rope there. What is she looking to do?
I feel like Gabby's been very, very consistent in this match. No signs of slowing down. Well, and then there
until
you go.
Until then, yeah.
You know what will stop you? A kick to the head.
Kick to the head all the time. It looks like Erica's picked up a little bit of a limp here, though.
Oh! Big spare. Gore.
Oh, just a two count. Very close. Very close. So, Gabby here is living up to the test. Now, a lot of people said coming into this match, how is Gabby going to perform against Erica? So far, she's hanging in there, and Erica looks a bit surprised even.
Yeah, I think when you're facing somebody, they're making their debut, you kind of almost shortchanged them. I think Erica's a little surprised by how impressive Gabby has been.
Yeah. Of course, we're in Ridgefield Park, the Mecca of East Coast Pro Wrestling. So everybody wants to make a mark and a big spear. Erica almost hit the bottom rope with the back of her head in the cover. Two, and that will be it.
Incredible win here. Erica, impressive as always. But Gabby making an impact right here at Wrestler's Lab.
Gabby Forza with a big upset victory. And I'll tell you what, I didn't see that coming. Erica Lee only suffered one defeat at Wrestler's Lab. I guess it's number two, Darnell. What a opening contest here. Oh! Holy crow! What is going on with this?
Look, I get it. She's frustrated. A second loss here at Wrestler's Lab.
Referee Rosie Jones asking her, said that this is not so typical of you, Erica. And Darnell, what about this behavior do you really commend?
You know, I understand it. It's sort of a mentality. It's an athlete mentality. That's being surprised here in the ring.
I guess that's me.
Hello, guys.
How about that? Debonair.
And she is sponsored by Pro Wrestling Mini Museum at www.wrestlingmuseum.net at PW Museum. Please welcome the Queen of the Ring, Alice. All right, with that said, we've got a big match for you now that has been 9 to 11 years in the making, depending upon which of its combatants you ask. This singles match is scheduled for one fall.
This one kind of scares me, Darnell.
First.
So they've been going back and forth on social media. Here comes Big Shotgun Adams.
Yeah, I'm really excited for this matchup. Shotgun Adams, of course, from T2T here in New York City in Brooklyn, representing. Shotgun, just like Gabby in the first match, he's got something to prove here.
He's got something to say, too.
You said you were gonna make me cry.
he's like a house of fire, is the urban mercenary.
Yeah, but can he keep that energy up when he's facing the one and only Akira?
Internationally known as the Death Fighter. Very decorated, former world middleweight and tag team champion in MLW. Raven in professional wrestling has taken this man under his wing. Akira, multiple tours with Big Japan Pro Wrestling, and he vows to bring violence to Wrestler's Lab. Now, Shotgun Adams, he's no slouch, but will Shotgun Adams be up to the test? Oh, here we go. And just ring the bell wherever the bell is. Let's get this going.
Shotgun's got a lot of energy. Keep in mind, he's had two losses here at Wrestler's Lab. So he's looking to prove himself tonight, and he's got a hell of a challenge in someone like Akira already to the outside.
And Darnell, I didn't want to mention that because I'm afraid the Shotgun will take it out on me, but he was choked out by Mr. Graham the last time we saw him. Oh, manipulating the joints in front of... Oh, no! Oh, paper cut to the urban mercenary!
Literally the most painful move in wrestling.
Oh, don't come near us. Darnell is dressed too nicely to have this around him. And this is starts as hot as I would think so. Shotgun Adams, usually known for choking people out for them ducats, not really today.
Now, Kara's a person who came here with a lot of intention. Once again, we've been in the outside the entire time. Oh.
Now later on, if you stay tuned, we have a 5-on-5 Mecha Mayhem, but right now, the weapons around the arena, Akira, the veteran, taking advantage of those. Now I've once seen Akira jump off a house, so, oh no, where are we going? Oh goodness.
Match is over.
Match is over, Darnell.
Akira's got to be careful. He's giving Shotgun a lot of time to get back to his feet. Well, he's got to stay on him. Oh, and there we go.
I hear Akira is hand-picking the weapons used. Oh, goodness! Which just flew in the air!
I think it was his soul.
Yeah. One more time! Oh, against every door, every nook and cranny. Now, Shotgun Adams has said he wants to be, oh, notorious in 2024. But he's just, Akira, the veteran, using that arm, abusing that arm any chance he gets.
Oh.
This is getting brutal, Darnell. Second match of the night.
Yeah, we're just giving a nice little tour of the Mecca here at Ridgefield Park, making sure everyone is accommodated.
Oh, is that a ladder? I didn't even see that when we got here.
Oh!
Shotgun might be knocked out there.
Yeah, he's literally throwing everything but the kitchen sink. Oh,
goodness!
My God.
Well, the Death Fighter swore to Shotgun Adams. He said, you keep running your mouth, and I'm going to show up to Wrestler's Lab, and here Akira is.
Crowd loving it.
Well, I guess this is how you learn up somebody. This is how you smarten up somebody. The urban mercenary, unlike him, is on the defense right now. But Shotgun Adams, a mental transformation, personality transformation, body transformation. He looks great.
And here's the thing. He's been really physical outside of the ring, of course. He's great with weapons. But in the ring, look at this. This man is a mercenary.
Was he trying to slam him in? Oh! shotgun, trying to suplex Akira out, but he just rings that arm again. Always working on that arm. Oh, he's got 5 seconds to break this one, Rosie.
Using the legs for a leverage here.
It's a great point. So Shotgun Adams really taking it to Akira now. Now it's interesting. So the beginning of the match was owned by Akira. Akira using his improv skills with all these weapons around, using that to his advantage. But everything out of the ring has been Akira. Everything in the ring has been Shotgun Adams.
Yeah, Shotgun's got to be really, really mindful about what he's doing in the ring, right? You can see that shoulder hurting him just a little bit from that ladder. So he's got to be really smart, be really technical with what he's doing here.
Ooh, big uppercuts in there. Sign up again. Oh, another big uppercut.
I like this energy from Shotgun. Keep on him. Oh, going for that peacemaker. That peacekeeper.
Nobody's keeping peace as of yet. Still on that arm, wrenching it back. And again, under the tutelage of Raven, Akira has been in pro wrestling. He's worked closely with Ricky Shane Page. In there with Sammy Callahan. He's the Death Fighter for a reason.
Yeah, incredibly well-rounded here.
Oh, no, this is... Ooh! Now, Akira placing Shotgun Adams' arm on the canvas and then just kicking it out from under him. Oh, goodness. Staring at Rosie that way.
There's not much you can do to reverse something like that. Shotgun's got to get some energy. He's got to get some adrenaline.
I think that was a version of a spinning forearm. Oh, they collide. Catches him this time. Picks up Akira, and over the back he goes. And here's the cover. Just a two count for the Urban Mercenary.
Interesting to note, that might be the first pinfall of the match, because they've just been beating the crap out of each other the entire time.
All over this place. Like you said, it was a tour of the whole facility. So if you haven't seen the Mecca after this match, you have.
Come on out to New Jersey, guys.
Yeah.
Straps are down.
And everybody knows what that means. Oh, goodness. Did you hear that, Darnell? It's just a huge bump. They're on the other side of the ring from us, but whatever's going on over there has to be crazy. Oh, they're choking each other out, I think, in front of the fans.
Little bird's eye view for them.
You get everybody groaning at what they're doing to each other. This was going to be physical. We knew that going in, and it is living up to the hype that these two set for this matchup.
I don't know how smart this is from Akira, taking a little breather. I know we all need it, but...
Yeah, that's a great point, Darnell. So Akira says, let's get back in the ring now. You want to have a show? Hey!
All right, Shotgun, come on.
It's hard to really defend something like that, Darnell. Oh. Hear him?
Yeah, the ref's got to get a little bit of control. Oh!
Slap to the face, Akira putting Shotgun back into his boots, huh?
That Shotgun's, he's kind of losing the plot here. He's got to keep focus here. More concerned with the ref, unfortunately.
Oh, back on that arm, back on that shoulder. Oh, just slapping him across the face. Bounce there. Oh, big boot, lifting that foot way up there. Kind of a gentleman's exchange, Darnell, huh?
A little back and forth. Oh. Right on the chin. Oh, Akira asking for more.
Oh.
Now, what do you say? What do you say to something like that? When someone just wants you to keep kicking them in the face?
Puts it there. Oh, there we go. Blows from all the way around. Spinning front forearm. Way to be. Oh, For a man who's made his name in ICW, Akira knows how he can pull out all the stops and front dropkick back to the turnbuckle. Running through, oh, big splash there. I think those new to Shotgun Adams knows that he is a screamer. He's a crazy guy. He's a mercenary.
He's a mercenary, but you can see how much pain that even that splash took out on him.
Front armbar through.
That arm has taken a beating.
That Muay Thai background of Akira to his advantage. And that arm he's been...
Nice little.
One, two. Two count. Now, Akira's been working on that shoulder, working on this arm, and that armbar could have ended things, but Shotgun made a veteran move and kind of made a pinfall out of it. Kick to the face, push against the ropes. Oh, Saito suplex of sorts. The Death Fighter on top.
Nice veteran move. You're right about that pin, but notice he can't get the shoulders down because of the impact of his own shoulder. He's not able to hit everything with that arm that he needs, and yeah.
Two. Oh, just a two count. Oh, you always have to.
You got to give it to Shotgun here.
Yeah, you always have to be threatened by that penalty kick from Akira. The Labradors here, Showa Bunga 2. Everybody having a good time. Again, this is Toddy Tondera with Darnell Mitchell. And right now, Shotgun Adams being choked out, but he stood up from all of that, but then just thrown over.
And he kept it locked in. That's incredibly hard to do.
Shotgun Adams was almost out on his feet, tried to get to his feet, and then just thrown over in a form of a German suplex. But again, Shotgun Adams is up, Darnell. Snapmare through.
Yeah, Shotgun is he's running on fumes here, but he's running on that determination. Again, those two losses have...
German suplex, two. Oh, just a two count. Oh, but there it is. There is that ankle lock switching from the shoulder and the arm to the foot.
Incredibly smooth transition here. Akira is, he's masterful to watch in that ring.
Yeah, Akira knows how to work a body part. Oh no. Rosie is down via Shotgun Adams again, disrespecting the referee. Akira helping Rosie up here. Is she okay to go? She's okay for now. Oh my God. Back elbow through and against the ropes. Oh, big spine buster. Two and, oh, just a two count. Just a two count.
This is a hell of a match going on here.
So it seems like once Shotgun Adams feels disadvantaged, that's when he tries to mess with Rosie the ref. And Akira, of course, is trying to help things move along here. So that's how Shotgun Adams... Oh, not this again.
It might not be the classiest, but I mean, it's been pretty impactful for him throughout this entire match. So I don't blame him.
Yeah, to your point, Danielle, it may not make him the most popular person in the room, but... It
as
sure
long
is working.
As those checks cash, that's all that matters.
Shotgun now to the top turnbuckle. What does he have in store? Took a little bit too long. Akira bats him in the head. Setting up here on the second rope. What do we have? Oh, Enziguri!
Right to that shoulder again.
From the floor. Geez, from the window to the wall was this match, huh? Got him. Akira has Shotgun Adams tucked up in the top rope. What does he have in mind here? Oh, he's holding that arm. Oh, no. Oh, there we go. Clutching it in.
He's got nowhere to go.
In the center of the ring here at Showa Bunga 2, Akira. Full attack on Shotgun Adams. The audience here is hoping Shotgun taps. Shotgun has shown some resiliency, and Shotgun Adams is defeated. The Death Fighter wins this one.
what an insane match. Impressive for both men. Akira really, really showed why he's in the position he is currently in independent wrestling.
Akira victorious despite some efforts of Shotgun Adams to pull out all the stops, including pushing the referee a lot, Darnell.
Not the most classy, but it was giving Shotgun a little bit of advantage there, but impressive nonetheless from Shotgun.
I hope Coda the dog is home watching Akira with this victory. What a debut for the Death Fighter. Everybody loves Gina here too, huh?
Yeah.
I see you already know, but please let me introduce you to this moment who is sponsored by Women's Wrestling Watch, WWW of NEO. Ladies and gentlemen, Gina Monty!
Heck yeah! Labradors here appreciating and respecting Gina as they should.
Well, with that said, we are about to have our pick-your-own-partner tag-team match. Now, the teams have already been chosen. Now it's time to meet them, introducing the first team.
Now, this match could be on any card and steal the show for show stealers in this competition. I see your head bobbing over there a little bit, Darnell.
I mean, it's Beyonce and it's Angelo Carter, one of my favorites.
Now this matchup, these competitors pick their tag team partner for the match. This is all built on the Frenemies A-game and Angelo Carter.
Both of them from TTT, but both of them have some history in tag teams. I mean, keep in mind, Angelo is a former Blitzburg tag team champion of 189 days. This is going to be quite exciting. Incredible singles wrestler, incredible tag team wrestler, and a Beyonce stan. So what's not
just
to love?
Incredible, just incredible in general. And of course, A-Game and Angelo, yeah, tagged together, started training together. So A-Game and Angelo picked their tag team partners for this match. Here's Angelo on Big Gay Brunch. Recent opponents, Sonny Kiss, Tracy Williams, amateur wrestler Reese Hayes, who you'll be seeing a little bit later. But Angelo's always unpredictable. Angelo has that special spark, and that's why they call him the Money Dragon. Angelo's tag team partner could manipulate a body part in so many different ways. And that's why Angelo added him to the mix.
It's an interesting juxtaposition. Someone like Angelo, who's not afraid to go to the top row, not afraid to be a little bit more out there, tagging with someone like Robert Martyr, of course. It was literally just, his objective was just to tear you apart limb by limb.
If you had to pick your tag team partner, would you pick me if it was up to you?
Of course.
Thank you. Even if
Absolutely.
You lied. Even if
Absolutely.
You lied.
Absolutely. We only lie on Tuesdays. We only lie on Tuesdays.
Not at the Mecca, right?
Not at the Mecca. Never. It's $3 beers. I could never lie here.
$3 beers?
It's incredible.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Angelo Carter picking Robert Martyr in this match.
Now it's time to meet the second team in tonight's Pick Your Own Partner Challenge.
This is hype too.
The one and only A-game. You know, a lot of representation here tonight from T2T, of course, out of Brooklyn. And I'm a little biased myself, but he's been one of the highest, like, he's been one of the best sort of signings for them. He's been one of the best people in that group. He is an incredible talent here.
And once he locks in the Fiend, you're going to be put to sleep. He's been in there with Joseph Alexander, the Boumaye Fight Club, a tactician. And we talked about this legitimately before we went live. His eyes are so intense.
Yeah, I got lost in them.
Yeah. And let's see his partner for this one, huh? This man is just simply intimidating. When I see him, I even back up my chair a little bit.
Oh, here we go.
O'Shea Edwards, a big powerhouse. Mr. Death to Fake Heavyweights himself is going to be tagging with A-game in there. As I mentioned before, this could main event anywhere.
Great strategy here also by A-game to pick someone like O'Shea Edwards. Keep in mind, he's the current Catalyst Heavyweight Champion. He's the Ohio Wrestling Alliance Champion. Who better than O'Shea Edwards?
Back to what I said, Darnell, if you had to pick a tag team partner and you picked O'Shea over me, all good. We're all good, dude.
No. I'll still keep you.
Cool.
Totally. Very smart strategies from both of these two. Very interesting there are tag team partners here.
There's going to be a lot of different unique style combos in here. Looks like Robert Martyr is going to be starting in there with A-game.
Great way to start the match. Both of them are incredible technicians.
Angelo amongst his fans and his own fan. Nose to nose are these two boys. Oh, getting low there.
Already, look at the eyes of Robert right here. He looks so focused.
Got to match that intensity of A-game, I suppose. Ooh, trying for that tackle through, grabs the leg, moves up, grabs around the wrist, but A-game trying to avoid that. Oh, look at that, spinning back around. Got him around the waist again. Ah, now he's just stunting on him, huh?
I was going to say, nothing fancy here, just some good old-fashioned wrestling. And then he pulled that one out, of course.
Yeah.
Robert taking a little bit of offense to the fan over here.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, here we go. That's really revved his engine. Look at him in there now. A-game with the gold shorts. Robert Martyr with the long black pants. Oh. Darnell, did you hear the audience there?
Yeah, there's no games here.
Test of strength coming up. Robert Martyr. Kind of like an octopus with all his limbs and stretching out every which way.
Yeah, Martyr's not here for a fun time. He's here to just get the match done, go home. That intensity that he has is incredible. He's got to be careful. A-game can have fun with all of them, but A-game himself is just, he's a powerhouse in that ring.
Robert Martyr making his lab debut. He stretches people out. He wants to make his opponents as uncomfortable as possible. He doesn't want them to get a breath of fresh air, some time away from the ring. He wanted to make their time as awful as it possibly get. Oh! Bridges out that and only a two count.
Excellent kip up.
A reversal against the ropes. Oh, shoulder tackle again. Robert Martyr. I mean, Robert Martyr's been in there with Suzuki, Tim Thatcher. He knows what he's doing. Roll through. Bounce against the ropes. Oh! Tit for tat there, Darnell.
I think these both of them seem to be pretty evenly matched here.
Kicking in the head. Oh, trip down. Oh, trying for the cover. But move. Oh, it's going to backslide. Two. Oh, just a two count.
That's the thing about Martyr. You got to keep your eye on Martyr. That man is slippery. If he can get a pinfall in, he's going for it.
Now, Robert Martyr is very familiar against his opponents, but this is the first time he's been in the ring with any of them. It's getting heated in there.
Yeah, I feel like A-Game is getting under his skin just a little bit.
The temperature just went up. Ducking through blocks. Oh! Double forearms meeting their match. Blocks the kick. Oh, whoa. Double kicks now. And look where they find themselves in their own corners. A couple of tags, and the Money Dragon is in there with the Big Bad Kaiju.
We were just talking about Robert and A-Game both being fantastic, but evenly matched. I love me some Angelo, but I'm not sure how evenly matched this is going to be right now.
Angelo is the moment. Everything he does is with precision and thought. And he's going right after the Big Bad Kaiju. Courage, too, from Angelo. Forearm. I think he's trying to knock the bigger competitor silly for a hopeful advantage.
And then it's over.
Oh!
Nice. Angelo's got to keep sticking and moving. Looking great in there in the ring.
Oh. There you go. And to your point, Darnell, as long as Angelo keeps moving, O'Shea may not be able to catch him.
Got to be careful. Doesn't want to go one-on-one straight for him. Just wants to knock the big man down.
Oh, kick, and it's caught. Oh, rolling through, though. Oh, there we go. Body on body. O'Shea is going to be the stronger of the two every time.
The most effortless just throw to the ground.
Yeah, great point, yeah. That took nothing. That man's so big. Oh. Angelo's partner, Robert Martyr, begging Angelo to get up.
Yeah, Elche's not giving you anything fancy in there. He's just going to beat you to a pulp.
He doesn't have to be fancy. When you're as big as tough as he is, you can just do whatever you want. Throw your weight around. You have that advantage. Up, slipping off the back. There we go. Front forearm. Up, bouncing against the ropes. Moving out of the way. Big speed. To the lower body. And Angelo's spear is one of the best that I've seen. When he torques the opponent's hips facing the direction that he wants them to go in. Oh! There's that power of O'Shea. Oh, forearm. Two on one. That's the only way to get this big bad kaiju out, Darnell.
Absolutely.
Oh. Did they see? I don't know that they saw that. So O'Shea is dumped to the outside floor here. But I'm not sure that they saw the tag, Darnell. But A-Game is...
I don't think they did either.
Oh, collision! Pushing each other into each other. Rolling up. Uh-oh. Two. Oh, just a two count. I thought that could be it. Martyr gets out. Headlock takeover. Their technical skills on display once again as we were talking about how this match started. Grabbing that leg.
Incredible chemistry between the two.
There you go, schoolboy, two. Oh, just a two count. Fast as lightning in there, it's hard to keep up. Oh,
Yeah, Robert and Angelo need to make sure they sort of keep that momentum and keep that impact on A-game. Don't want O'Shea back in there. They can keep him in the corner. They can concentrate on him. They just might eke out the victory here.
And Robert Martyr attempting to ground A-game because, as you see, Angelo is still not back up on the apron. Oh, goodness. A big death hold there by Big O'Shea. Two on one advantage, stomping down here. Oh, punching body shots, punching him. Gina in between the two. I mean, this is Showa Bunga too, so I think letting it slide a little bit. Oh, big stomp. Just a two count.
Notice how he kept the leg. He was immediately going to go for something right afterwards, focusing on that limb.
Pretty disrespectful. Oh, there we go. Cinching it through. Robert Martyr. Oh, up to their feet again. Over the back, planting them. And here comes the powerhouse back into the ring, and this is not a position you want to be. You don't want to be in the back, laying on your back when Big O'Shea Edwards comes in. Oh!
Incredible. They're cutting off the ring here.
Slamming down. Oh, Angelo trying to get back in, but of course. Oh, behind you, Gina. Look what's going on. Oh, man.
See, I mean, I will say, he did end at the 5 seconds, so.
Well, you would say that, Darno. Bounce against the ropes, duck under. Here comes Martyr flying around. Oh, and caught. Big mistake.
I was about to say big meaty man.
Oh, the power.
Oh, my God.
You can hear the gasp of awe of the Labradors here.
What a tag. It's still in awe.
Oh, what? Oh, no. Oh, small package. Two. Oh, just a two count. And in comes Angelo. We are fired up now. The Money Dragon making his moment. Front forearm.
Not the receipt.
Off the second rope. Oh, a version of a Hurricane Rana sends his frenemy across the ropes.
You don't want to allow Angelo to get fired up like this. He will fly around the ring like nobody's business.
Oh!
And
A-game scouted it. I mean, they've been frenemies for so long.
Exactly. Both members of T2T, so they know each other like crazy.
Big famouser. Two! Oh, just a two count. Not yet. What the heck is going to happen here, Darno?
This is incredible. This is incredible. Oh.
They've tried every which way to ground Angelo Carter. Anytime Angelo Carter gets his speed up, he's cut off at the pass. But the Labradors here at the Mecca, they know who they want. Oh. Grinding down, and here comes O'Shea again. Just a two count. But can this team of O'Shea in A-game put in the death knell? So far, not so much.
Notice how when he was doing those... that's just disrespectful.
That might be the nail in the coffin.
I love those pins by O'Shea. He's not looking to win the match right there. He's just looking to bring him down just a little bit. A big man like that over top of you, you're going to start losing energy.
Yeah. The range of superstars that Angelo Carter has been in the squared circle with makes him as dynamic as the performer you see today. Oh, choking on that second rope. Not so dynamic from Big O'Shea. In comes Martyr. Oh, no. Oh. O'Shea excusing Robert Martyr.
He's not wrong there.
He isn't, I'll give you that. But you don't want to fire Robert Margera.
O'Shea almost looks like he's just playing with Angelo.
Yeah.
But both of them have got to make sure they stay on Angelo. Because the second he starts flying around, it's over.
The boxing background of a game. Snapped around. Trying to reach for Robert Martyr's hand, but those mat wrestling skills, A-game has Angelo grounded. The crowd is getting behind the Money Dragon. Oh, reaching over again. Oh, we are so close. Oh, back elbow there. Super kick. A-game still on his feet and blocks that what I believe was an overhead T-bone. Oh, catches the foot down. Oh, Enziguri. Finish him. Do you hear that, Darnell? He said finish him. They said finish him, but Angelo heard that too and got a spark from it. Oh.
Once again, evenly matched.
And Darnell, this is how we knew it was going to be very honest, we knew it was going to be these two fighting like this. Oh! Like a car collision. A-game and Angelo Carter both down. Now they both need to reach their fresh tag team partners, but can they do it? The Labradors are behind Angelo. Of course, if they don't answer a 10 count, that means this match is thrown out, which nobody wants to see. Oh no! That was taking a little bit too long for O'Shea Edwards. Interferes while they were both attempting to tag their partners and just gives a big forearm to Robert Martyr.
It also allows his tag team partner, A-game, to get a little bit of his breath in, relax just a little bit. Very, very smart by O'Shea.
Is O'Shea trying to teach a lesson? Oh! Jack in that jaw.
Ref's got to get a little bit of control in here.
Grabbing onto that leg, trying to bust through again. Angelo doing everything he can to break through that and tag in Martyr, but O'Shea is so strong and so big. He's got him on one leg. Oh, slams back down. I don't know what condition anyone's going to be in after this match, to be very honest with you. Martyr's coming in, reaching around the back, but here comes Angelo flying again.
It's like running into a brick.
Oh! Chopping down that tree. Hits the ropes again. Front shotgun dropkick to the knees.
What a flurry of moves there by Robert Martyr.
He's got everybody looking. Everybody needs to have eyes in the back of their head when you're in there with Robert Martyr. Speaking about the back of the head, O'Shea Edwards just smacked with that German suplex here. Oh! Big suplex down. You could hear that rumble throughout the Mecca.
How is he doing this? Just incredibly impressive by Martyr.
Until A-game does that. Robert Martyr thrown out by A-game. Nemeca coming live for Angelo Carter once again. And still to come, please join us. We have Eel O'Neill versus Trevor Eon for that Wrestler's Life title in our main event. But right now, Big O'Shea eating a spear. Oh. Up schoolboy roll up. No, roll through. Kick. Angelo is going to go for that season finale, but look at this, the athleticism of A-game. Oh, he comes correct every time.
I cannot believe these guys still have this energy this far into the match.
Oh. I think all four of these competitors are going to need help out of this ring, Darnell. Oh, watch out behind you. Oh, you see his neck snap back. Oh, what is up now? Oh. That's
just
it for him.
Just one hand. Angelo to the top.
Oh, behind the Meteora. Holy crow, I didn't see Angelo coming. The Money Dragon. Proving why he is the moment. Oh. It's almost like a Uranagi. Two. Oh. Bring him up. A game in O'Shea victorious at Showabunga 2.
That was an incredible feat by all four of these competitors.
Now that came as advertised, Darnell. You knew A-Game and Angelo when they were selecting their partners. They want to introduce as much pain to their opponents as possible. And today at Showabunga 2, A-Game, O'Shea Edwards, victorious.
Absolutely. You know what? I can't even offer any criticism about both of their partners. That was incredible. And it's a really, really smart, really logical decisions for their partners. It was just going to be who was going to get that 1-2-3, who was going to outsmart them all. That was a sight to see.
And we are just getting started here. So, yeah, if you're live here at the Mecca, watching on YouTube in the future, make sure you put another pizza in the oven.
Hugs.
And like,
friend, we love hugs here.
Yeah, as friend and me as much do. They're, once that bell rings, A-Game and Angelo were at one another, but you know, if you train with them, hugs at the end. Way to be. Nice little crowd here, huh, Darnell? I'm having a good time.
I am too. I think the crowd is having an amazing time. This has just been an honor.
Eli Hush, I wanted to get your... Hey, hi. I wanted to just get your thoughts on your... Okay, how are your... Yeah, that's a microphone. Yeah, it's on. It's on. If you... I'm boxed in. Hi. Yeah. So you have to get ready for your match with Don't Die Miles. I can't. You just put me in a box. Oh. Yeah. Have fun. Guess Eli's ready.
Hello, Steve. You know, I didn't get a chance to thank my own sponsor, Adam Schwab. Thank you, Adam. This man not only shows up weekend after weekend here at the Mecca, but you also are very active with sponsorship, and we thank you for everything you do. So thank you, Adam Schwab, once again. Also, I want to thank one of our ringside photographers, Nicholas Lee Ruiz. You can find him at that exact name on Instagram, and probably see many of the photos captured here today. But with that said, Gina, it's time for our next singles match. And this match is scheduled for one fall.
One fall!
Singles action's next.
First.
I don't see you dancing to this music as much.
Never tell you that mime's kind of freaked me out just a little bit.
Didn't know that. And Eli Hush making his way to the lab from Malmo, Sweden. Here comes a brand new experiment for all you Labradors. He's trying to introduce us all to the science of silence, trained by former Progress champion Cara Noir. Now Eli Hush has competed in Sweden, England, Denmark, and Dubai. Impressive.
All right, and his opponent.
Time to get hype. You ever seen the Hippolytes? No, I ain't feeling sorry. Been in the kitchen bumping out the variety. I've been in the crib going crazy. I've been in the one for the day.
Gabby's work cut out going against Don't Die Miles, the current Summit Pro High Elevation Champion. I have a feeling this is going to be a nice, fast-paced matchup.
They were originally scheduled to face Hippie Dickie Moon, so Eli Hush is a different opponent than what Don't Die Miles had in mind. But again, they are a regular Naptown pro. They're all over the place. I was first introduced to Don't Die Miles at MV Young's Polycult shows, which you obviously remember.
Absolutely. My buddy Michael. My buddy MV.
And we are slated to get everything ready to go here in this one-on-one match. I thought we were going to get a silent bell.
A little showmanship here from Eli.
Yep. A little handshake to start off this contest, looks like. Very good. You'll love to see this. Oh, no, don't.
Wait.
Turn that off for a second.
Wait.
I think this might be a production error.
You've got to be kidding me.
Is this
happening? You've got
happening?
To be kidding me.
I can't see this in my notes at all. Who's coming out? Is this who I think it is, Darnell?
If it is, I swear I might die.
I didn't see him. I don't know why he would be here. Oh, goodness.
The one, the only, Darius Carter is here at Show of Bunga 2.
The All-Father is gracing Show of Bunga 2 with his presence, but I don't know why he's out here right now.
I don't
he's
know
got
why
a
he's
mic.
Out here either, but I'm happy to see him.
Is he trying to put himself in this match?
I think that's what's happening.
All father behavior here for sure.
Disrespect here today, actually, and Show Bunga.
I don't like how he said woman. Lifting up the rope, huh?
Thank you, Gina! Thank you, Gina!
One of those referees that thinks it's about you. Go in the business for yourself.
This stuff hurts to see, Darnell.
Is this going to be a triple threat? What type of authority does Darius actually
have
here?
He has the floor.
I'll allow it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
You are right. He is inserting into this match.
It looks like it's official.
So Eli Hush, Don't Die Miles, Darius Carter, Triple Threat, Showa Bungatu. Thank you, Shane. I guess we can just do that, right? He can just... The Look, bell is going to be ringing here.
Always something new here at Wrestler's Lab. Now, the dynamic has changed quite a bit. Darius Carter, if you don't know Darius Carter has just been a force the past couple of years here in the independent wrestling. He was number 144 in Pro Wrestling Illustrated. He's the BCW World Champion. He's the Wild World Heavyweight Champion. He's the ECWA Champion. This man has accolades like crazy, and he's got forearms like that.
And the 2022 Super 8 winner is Darius Carter. But Darnell... These two, especially Don't Die Miles. Don't Die Miles.
Oh! Oh, a little tag team action here.
A little shooter to the sling blade. How about that, old father? Don't Die Miles, they and Eli Hush. Oh!
That's a big man to get out of the ring. Impressed by these two.
So are these two going to keep together against Darius for now? Or, yeah, that's what I thought. Oh, no, friends, once that bell rings, hip toss, look how quick. Holy crow, cover. Two! Oh, just a two count. Darnell, you were mentioning before, Don't Die Miles. Quick, agile, around the place they are. Eli Hush might be kryptonite.
Very smart for the two to also get Darius out of the ring. Keep the focus on one another.
Ooh. Eli Hush kicking out. Oh, they came at him with a... Up. But guess who's still standing? Kip up for Don't Die Miles. They are on top. Oh! Big double clothesline.
You have always got to keep your focus. If Darius Carter is in the matchup, he will take every advantage that he can.
Would you consider yourself a bit of a Darius Carter guy?
Is it coming through?
It's coming through, Darnell.
I mean, look, the guy's not... He doesn't always say the nicest things, but you know what? We're here for wrestling. This man is a champion in multiple divisions, and he's champion for a reason.
Dishes Eli Hush out. The All-Father has them up. Slam down, stalking his prey, the younger Don't Die Miles.
And once again, yeah, triple threat match, every person for themselves,
yep.
But both of them have got to team up to cut down the 6'4" Darius Carter.
6'4", you say?
Yeah, I'm going with that number.
He is tall. Oh.
And the second best dressed person here.
Oh, that's what you're getting at.
Yeah, buddy.
Just punishing both of his opponents is Darius Carter. Oh, scratching at the eyes of Eli Hush. Oh. Oh, did you hear that?
Thud.
Well, of all the folks that have been in the ring today at Show Bunga 2, it seems like Darius Carter is one of their least favorites of the Labradors here at the Mecca. Picks them up, and oh goodness!
That was actually pretty terrifying.
I was almost standing up. I thought they were going to land on their head. Oh, that's not going to work. Look up! Look there. No, seriously though, there's.
Right to the chest.
big impact there with the drop kick. And again, Darius Carter slowing the pace down. Darius, being a veteran of the business, notices Don't Die Miles and Eli Hodge. They're all over the place, bouncing off the walls. Darius Carter slowing things down like only the All-Father can. Stomping on the arm, stomping on the hand, something like that.
Probably one of the most methodical wrestlers out there at the moment. Everything that Darius does has incredible intention. He's got to make sure that he doesn't undermine Eli and Don't Die Miles here.
Oh, I don't know that Eli can scream, but I'm sure if Eli could, he would. Taking off the glove, wiping the sweat away. Oh, goodness. Oh, a bird of a middle finger getting twisted all around. Darnell, I got to close my eyes. This is rough.
Oh, God. Did you hear that?
Well, I didn't see it. My eyes were closed, but I certainly heard it. Miles is on top. Oh, they just were cut down.
That's that veteran moves. Eyes in the back of his head.
Look at that smile on the face of Darius Carter. Wicked. Wicked.
Oh. I'm not saying he likes to inflict pain, but I'm not saying that he likes to inflict pain.
Fair enough. Don't Die Miles. Precariously, they are on that top turnbuckle. Oh. Hits down Darius. Oh, there we go. And that's why they don't want them to die.
Almost touched the ceiling there.
Through the ceiling. Challenging Darius to come forward. And they are on attack with that forearm strike. Shh. He doesn't see him behind him. Oh, a little tag team maneuver. What a combination there by Eli Hush.
This is what Darius doesn't want. He doesn't want Eli, he doesn't want Miles to team up with him. He doesn't want that pace to quicken.
And this is what Wrestler's Lab is all about. Brand new experiments. And we have one in the ring right now.
Oh.
Shot to the gut. Bouncing off the top. Oh!
Incredible form there.
Eli rolling out of the ring, avoiding being covered. Don't Die Miles, they are up on their feet. Over the back. Hanging on still, up, block. Oh, kick to the back of the head. Springboard for,
oh my
God. Two, oh, just a two count. A kick to the gut. Ah.
Very, very smart ring awareness there by Eli.
And Darnell, we've seen some pretty stiff competition in there, but that kick to the gut, I don't know, that was wild.
And yeah, there's no way to avoid that. There's no way to be able to take that.
Eli Hush begging off a little bit. Coming through. Oh, flips through the ropes. They said, come on, come on. Oh, goodness. He said, come on, come on, come on. Oh. Gonna try it again. Springing over! Oh! The silent cutter. The cover. One, two. Oh! And guess who isn't friends all of a sudden? It's Don't Die Miles and Eli Hush. They both want that victory here at Showbunga 2.
As they should. It's one of the reasons why I love triple threat matches. You gotta make sure you know what's happening in that ring at all times.
All three competitors down on the canvas, getting up to their knees. Oh, thud of an uppercut. Another thud of an uppercut. Oh, goodness. You ever been hit like that?
No, and I hopefully don't plan on that happening anytime soon whatsoever.
Oh. Slide attempt.
It's not the nipples. I felt that all the way over here.
Sure, Darius doesn't like games being played like that, but Darius is going to eat a double super kick. Oh, the energy Eli is trying to bring off the ropes. Springing board off. Oh! Wow! Here comes Don't Die Miles with that next gear energy. They are up on the top rope. Oh!
Swanton! A spirit bomb from the top rope. Oh!
That was crazy! Oh! Small package! Two! Just a two count. Don't Die Miles shoved into the turnbuckle by Darius Carter. Darius looking to take advantage. Oh, didn't get all of it, but it stutters.
But he got enough.
Stutters Darius back, flipping over. Caught, looking for that silent cutter again. Oh, to the center of the ring.
And it's over.
Two, three. The All-Father wins at Showabunga 2. Well, you heard Shane, Mr. Darius Carter, your boy Darnell, victorious here today.
My boy, and I gotta give credit where credit is due. Don't Die Miles and Eli Hush, both very, very good here tonight, both incredible. But what do you do when a wild card like Darius Carter comes into the ring?
A few minutes before this match started, Eli Hush and Don't Die Miles thought they were going one-on-one, but the All-Father inserted himself and effectively got himself the victory. And again, thank you so much. If you're watching at home on YouTube in the future, I'm Toddy Tondera.
And I'm Darnell Mitchell.
And this is Wrestler's Lab Showabunga 2. Thank you for joining us. I'm reading all of your comments from the future. They're great. Thank you for commenting.
We're four matches in, and this entire show has been, oh!
Nose to nose, oh! Sheesh, I wouldn't want to go nose to nose with either of those two. Person in the hoodie looked pretty tough.
I didn't find it.
I don't know where the creeps are.
Did you check your laundry?
I already checked my laundry.
Did you check your gear bag?
The gear is in there, but the belt isn't. I'm telling you, the creeps have it. There's no way it...
We didn't see. Okay, the creeps definitely took it.
Yes.
Okay, yes.
I know the creeps took it, and I'm gonna find them, because they must have my belt if it's not in here. Creeps!
Winners tonight. Now we implore all of you, the Labradors, because this is your time to shine. If you brought a weapon, it's time to unsheathe it and get that weapon ready for this next match. A 10-man fans bring a weapons match. Now I join you in advance. This is going to come to every corner of the building, but it comes your way. Just be forewarned, this match is scheduled for one fall.
Darnell, I saw that stop sign in your card. Is that for this match?
Maybe. I might have some other tricks on my sleeve.
5-on-5 Mecha Mayhem coming up. And 880 Wrestling's own amateur wrestler Reese Hayes coming out first.
Any of us are prepared for what is about to transpire.
And of course, Reese Hayes hanging out with Reese's Row. Darnell, that whole section over there is for this young man, the 880 champion, Reese Hayes.
I'm really excited to see them wrestle. Never seen them wrestle before live.
Get excited, for sure. Now, he, of course, is a part of T2T Pittsburgh in the adjacent promotion 880 Wrestling. He currently holds the 880 Championship. So he's my boy. So Darius may be yours, but this kid's mine.
Respect. T2T from T2T Brooklyn. Delightful. Damn, that goddamn candy, man. I kind of want some candy. Hopefully he comes over here.
I've had so much of Candyman's candy over the years that I now have bad teeth. And as you mentioned, Darnell, T2T Brooklyn's own, and he was a last-minute pick by MV Young. MV Young was supposed to be here today feeling under the weather, so he picked one of his favorite wrestlers to replace him, and that's the Candyman, Delightful Dan. Oh, I could feel the shift in the room now.
Comes the urban playboy himself, Pretty Boy Smooth.
And as Shane said, 285 pounds, 6'9", from Hempstead, New York, Pretty Boy Smooth, the urban playboy. Last time we saw him, he was tagging with MV Young.
Don't let his slides and emer confuse you. This man is incredible in the ring. This man is a powerhouse. This is the person I would want on my team. Absolutely.
Fair pick. Fair pick.
My abs are not fake.
Arguably the most powerful man that's going to be in this matchup. I mean, have you seen those abs? They're totally not fake. Totally not fake.
Abs, the last time we saw abs was defeated by Perfect Perkins at 7 years of Science, and totally not fake abs. Big body guy, Darnell. It's always helpful to have somebody with those types of muscles on your team.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So we have 4 of the 5 of Team 1 so far. And it's not a party without abs. Now, their tag team partner this evening, I want to offer a big welcome back from Wrestler's Lab.
It is time to hit on pause.
Get up and dance and have fun. Full circle moment for this competitor.
Wow. You can feel the energy. It's been 11 long months and he is home.
Unfortunately, Big Game Leroy was injured, out for a long extended period of time. Until this very moment, his life has been as miserable as it's ever been, but BGL is back for redemption at Wrestler's Lab.
You can feel the energy oozing off of him. We can't wait to get back in that ring.
Team 1 for Mecha Mayhem. This is quite the team. Got a big strong guy, got a candy man.
Got perfect abs.
It seems like the Labradors love Big Game Leroy. Let's find out who's in this next team, Darnell. He's wrapped. BJJ blue belt, trained by Cheeseburger over at the ROH Dojo, a black belt in Taekwondo. And last time we saw Ryan Mooney, he was with Andy Brown going 2-on-2 against MV and PB at 7 Years of Science. So that's how the Rabbit Honey Badger ended up in this match. Who's coming out next here, Darnell?
And here we go. I mean, we were talking about the other team and how impressive they are, but whew.
Yeah, there's nobody more impressive than Aaron Ashe, and he's here at Wrestler's Lab to be a champ. He wants that gold here. International pro wrestler, your ruler. He's been in there a lot with O'Shea Edwards as well. Those two hosses fighting each other.
I'm shocked the ring can actually handle all this.
As the Labradors clap in tune. The energy in the room has shifted.
You know, we've been talking about T2T. Talk about T2T Brooklyn, and here is the head trainer themselves, Logan Black, in the house.
I'm always scared of Logan. He's very intense. Head trainer at T2T Brooklyn, as Darnell said, part of the Queer Punk Outlaws, was a part of Effie's Big Gay Brunch with the East Coast team, which made up T2T Brooklyn. But the King of Chaos is here. The Wild West Skyscraper hits the Mecca for 5-on-5 Mecca Mayhem here at Showabunga 2. And oh, the Black Cowboy doesn't like Reese's Row, apparently.
I'm so excited to see TJ. I'm so excited to see Perfect Perkins here. You know what I really need? I need Perfect Perkins, and I need Pretty Boy Smooth in that ring together immediately.
You know what I need? Half the looks of Perfect Perkins. Look at his abs. They're just as impressive as abs. 255 pounds of whiskey and cigars. The Wild West Skyscraper. He'd have been a first-round pick for me. Now, this next competitor, which makes five here, was also a late addition to the team. So let's see what that chemistry has for our second team. But just as you said, Darnell, look at all the meat in the ring. Is this the ring just going to fall over? There's not even anything happening yet. It's already sagging. And I didn't know rings did that until right now.
And his next competitor will be also another debut here for us here at Wrestler's Lab.
Some call him the King of the Mecca. Ryman, as you heard Shane say, the Magic Kingdom Ripper wrestled in 5 countries and in one night to get the Pro Wrestling Magic Championship had to beat Dan Moff in a dog collar match, and they went on to beat Adam Kerr same night.
Yeah, if you've come here, if you've come to the Mecca, if you've been to Retro Park, you know Alex. Alex is the current Pro Wrestling Magic Champion. He's been so impressive for the past couple of years. Yeah, this is going to be a hell of a match.
What a last-minute draft pick, right? Exactly. The king of the Mecca?
Who better than the champion himself?
So weapons are completely legal. In fact, I don't know that there are rules at all. This is going to break down quickly. But this is scary. I've been on the edge of my seat since I heard the announcement of this, and I'm not sure what this is going to look like, Darnell, but it's going to be violent. Here we go. Perfect Perkins starting in there with Reese Hayes. Now, look at Reese's row. They're standing up for young Reese.
Yeah, clearly Perkins has got the size advantage, but maybe that fan support will give Reese exactly what he needs to break down the big man.
Perfect Perkins says he's going to teach this tenderfoot a lesson at the Mecca at Showabunga 2, and we're about to see that now. Perkins has always shown disrespect to amateur wrestler Reese Hayes. This is Reese's time to stand up to the Wild West skyscraper and do what he does best. Not that, Darnell.
Yeah.
This Perfect Perkins was a part of the Boumaier Fight Club. Picking that one leg up. I mean, honestly, that's the best I can do.
I was thinking to myself, I was like, what is your strategy here? You knock him down, right?
I mean,
chop
I don't
him
know.
Down, but like with thighs like that, I'm not so sure you can chop him down.
Perfect Perkins looks like he was created in a lab.
A wrestler's lab?
A wrestler's lab and also a chemical lab.
yeah. That's all you can do is just fall.
In comes Delightful Dan. Reese tagging out, maybe switching things.
Well, that's very nice.
Huh.
Who doesn't like candy?
A little sucker for, LPP, and he says, I'm no sucker. Now, surprisingly, Delightful Dan, the Candyman, is quite tall and quite big, and people don't say that enough about Candyman. He's a thumper.
He is, absolutely. Like, I know he's playful, I know he's fun, I know he provides us with candy, but that's a big boy, that's a strong man in that ring, and athletic.
Ah, how about that? Ah! He's witty, too. He's gonna outsmart LPP. Told ya!
Work smarter, not harder.
Two! Oh, imagine if the Mecha Mayhem ended right there! Spinning around. Two. Oh, just a two count.
I love this, man.
Delightful Dan, you don't want to be in unfamiliar territory over there. Yeah, Watch yourself.
He's pretty delightful.
But the specimen that is the Wild West skyscraper. Oh! Hubba Bubba Bomb! And the cover. Two and sweet. Oh, I was going to say sweet treats for a count of three, but not so fast. Here comes the real body guy. Totally not fake abs across the ring from Rabid Ryan Mooney.
Yeah, I'm thinking to myself, where do you go for abs? Can't hit him in the abs, it's too strong.
I don't know how you prepare for someone like Ryan Mooney. He just jets around.
Yeah, I feel like there's a rhyme or reason. He's just going to...
Shades of Perfect Perkins. We've got a six-pack in the ring. As somebody, one of the Labradors said here, must be the abs. I don't know, getting in there with somebody with rabies, I don't know how trustable that is. grinding in that headlock against the ropes. Oh, meeting each other in the ring. You can't take down totally not fake abs.
Abs not following the rule book here.
Says, if I gotta fall down, you gotta make me. Against the ropes. Ugh. Not so fast.
Mooney's gotta get himself under control here. Maybe the third time, you know.
Mm-hmm. I think Ryan Mooney challenged Abs to charge at him back. I get, oh, well, there you go. That's why. He's on the opposing corner here in the 5-on-5 Mecha Mayhem. They're a bit scoundrelly, but guess what? These abs are totally not fake.
Hey, it's part of the, you know, it's not against the rules, like.
Oh, pop up. Oh.
That is.
Ab to the face. That's not against the rules. I don't know if there's any rules
at
all, Darnell.
I'm starting to think that these abs might be fake.
Picking up Mooney. Oh, gets out of the grip of abs.
I take that back.
I think holding his wrist there. I think abs is really waiting for Mooney to challenge him.
I wonder who's going to be the first competitor to grab something from the crowd.
Yeah. I think Mooney was accusing abs of having a steel plate.
Which,
in
legal.
His abs? Have you ever heard of something like that? I think Mooney, those rabies are catching up, yeah. That'll slow you down. Man of the People is totally not fake abs.
The crowd is loving it. I mean, it's pretty rare to see a beautiful specimen on the ring with abs like that. So, like, take my breath away.
But just look at the fray of competitors out there, Darnell. Big PB Smooth, Thick Logan Black, a Candyman, a Wild West Skyscraper. We have the assortment of experiments for Showa Bunga 2 is an experimental. Is that, I believe, a nice little butt bite, huh?
Look, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
Now, is that gonna pass on to abs? Or whatever Mooney has? Oh, big boot. And the cover. Two. Oh. Just a two count. Oh, grabbing on to the bottom rope.
Who wants to see the big man in here?
Do you want to see Big Pretty Boy?
Yeah, calling for Pretty Boy Smooth. I don't know if that butt bite's gonna work for him, though.
Over the top rope, those long appendages of PB Smooth. They call him the Urban Playboy. I don't think Mooney wants any of that. I don't think he wants any of that.
I don't blame him. That's 6'9", 285 pounds of just meat.
Oh.
Look at his face.
Calm, cool, and collected.
Calm, cool, and collected.
Oh, he has what in his boots?
Lifts in his boots, I guess.
You're going to get smacked for that, I believe. Oh, I guess. That was the only way to meet eye to eye with PB and says, whatever your tricks are, dude, I'll just throw you around. And Mooney, out of here.
Tagging in the champion, the Pro Wrestling Magic champion.
Oh, duck under. Pushing PB Smooth. Well, some people say they have beer muscles. I think this individual has mecha muscles and oh, the muscles of PB Smooth throw him against the corner. Oh, big slap to the chest. Yeah. Oh.
I'm not sure what a.
Oh, you heard that.
I have a chop off with Pretty Boy Smooth at all.
down to the canvas. The revolver is getting shot around this ring. Oh, tossed like a bag of potatoes. In comes the returning big game Leroy.
First time in the ring in 11 months. Big game Leroy is ready to go.
Turnbuckle to turnbuckle. Up, foot up. Here comes Leroy. Oh, back elbow as his teammates cheer for that. The king of the Mecca on top right now. And here he comes, the king of chaos. Slipping over is Leroy against the ropes. Oh, duck under the double axe handle. Hurricane run into Logan Black. And welcome back, big game. We missed you. Oh, big forearm there. I think he was looking for a bulldog there, but caught off guard. Duck under. A little bit of a wheelbarrow.
Almost thought Logan had that counter for a second.
Oh, goodness.
Oh! That's a blow to the back. That'll stop anybody.
Oh, this is really going to break down. The big Aaron Ashe in the ring. And this is what we talked about in pregame, Darnell. With five competitors with this explosive energy coming from, and it's going to all break down. Yeah. I don't know that Rosie Jones can do much about this.
Rosie, just hope for the best.
So from here on out, Darnell, this is going to be really hard to fight, to call this, but we're going to try over there. Reese Hayes.
I see kendo sticks in the corner.
Reese Hayes over there with the king of the Mecca. Filming through here. Oh, into the audience right in front of us. Everybody went pair to pair. They're pairing up and just beating the heck out of each other.
Almost have to have your head on a swivel, action just everywhere.
And thank you for Scotty for filming this. Scotty Swemba, we love him, but this is a lot for Scotty. A lot for all of us. Oh, Mooney with a garbage can lid, I did see that. PB Smooth now has a hockey stick? Oh boy. It is everywhere. There are bodies everywhere. Just kind of, I'm trying to see where everyone is.
It's just thud, thud, thud.
Oh, I think Reese Hayes had a big water jug. Oh. Over there, big game Leroy and the king of the Mecca. Big game Leroy currently on top here. What do you have on the other side? We got kendo sticks, hockey sticks still.
We got a kendo stick off here between Abs and Aaron.
Oh, Logan Black choking Reese Hayes out. Reese's Rowe very disappointed in what's happening right now. Oh, watch yourself. PB and Perkins are coming our way. I'm way too small to be near them.
I'm a little scared for the table. I'm a little scared for the table.
But over there in front of the ring. Oh, the King of the Mecca has some sort of packaging that just smacked. Oh, coming across here.
Pretty boy, yeah, Perkins are a little close to my friend Alex over here, Queen of the Ring.
Be careful, Queen of the Ring is in.
Be careful.
Oh, kids around. But back over there, Ryan Mooney now on attack. Oh, with a sword. Ryan Mooney has a sword, and Reese Hayes is blocking what seemed to be some type of package or some type of box. Oh, head in the box, how about that? Amateur wrestler, our babyface hero. Meanwhile, back in the ring, Alex Ryman and Candyman. Big punch over up on the apron, and this is truly Mecca mayhem. This is Show of Bunga 2, and oh! Springboards off the ropes, Candyman moved out of the way. Coming at him again, tripping through, and he dives through! Oh, goodness. And in comes Perkins, oh, big boot!
Action just everywhere. Oh, now we got Abs and Perkins in the ring.
The two body guys. And maybe there is a steel plate in those abs because Perkins looks like he's knocked out. In comes Aaron Ashe. I don't know that Abs knows.
Oh, just took his head off.
Oh, Reese.
I might not be the smartest.
Oh, Reese, did he bite off more than he can chew? The easy answer is yes, but we shall see.
You gotta love the determination, though. You gotta love the confidence.
Oh, thrown him back. Duck under the clothesline. Up, caught. Samoa drop. Goodness gracious. This is Mecha Mayhem.
No weapons needed there, just pure strength.
Pulling Reese up by the thick, gorgeous locks.
Pretty
PB Smooth
move.
Is in there. Ooh. Catching him! Ooh. Oh, assisted cutter! Thank you, PB! Meanwhile, Ryan Mooney is on the top rope with that sword. Out of the way is PB. Oh, gets the sword out of his hand. Oh, what is he setting up here for?
Long way down.
Almost like a penthouse blue for PB Smooth. Mooney's in the ring. Leroy's over here. We got garbage can lids. People better watch out of the way.
They gotta get out of the way. Aaron and Pretty Boy Smooth together.
Oh boy, there's a ball flying. I'm feeling pretty scared, Darnell. Oh.
You can just
over
feel
here.
The ground rumbling.
Oh, yes. That's a perfect way to put it. Meanwhile, in the ring, Candyman Logan Black, the King of Chaos. Oh, no. Oh, shoving an action figure down the throat of the Candyman. Oh, the King of Chaos introducing a little jaw jack. I don't know that Candyman knows where he is. This isn't very delightful, Darnell.
Yeah, that running punch, he calls out the Chelsea grin. I don't think
nobody's
Dan's
going
to be grinning after this. Oh, here comes Logan. Oh,
what is this?
Oh, he's taking a pizza.
Is that what that is? It's a pizza.
Yeah, right?
From the Queen
it's
of the
Red. For the Turtles.
That was for the Turtles. That was taken off the Queen of the Ring for the Turtles, but I guess Logan Black...
Why does he have a grin on his face?
I don't know. I don't know that he's hungry.
What's in the box? Oh, no. Alex, what did you do?
I don't know how many blocks are in this playset, but there's nothing to play about right now. The King of Chaos. Oh, ripcord around. Oh, jawjack. What a precarious position. Oh. And much like Popeye is to spinach, the Candyman feels the sugar in his hands.
You've gone too far.
I might agree with you here, Darnell. This Candyman gone too far. Begging Logan Black on. Hubba Bubba Bomb part two. It. Elbow. Inflatable bat. Oh, big suplex on the Legos. Oh. Little taste of his own medicine in the cover. Two. Oh, just a two count. BGL breaking it up. Even Big Game is taking this serious. He's put his switch down for today.
I don't even know where we go from here. Just body sprawled everywhere.
Oh, a little 3-on-1? Oh! Oh, Big Game Leroy's gonna attempt to take on all three of his opponents here.
You gotta love the heart from Leroy.
That's a great point. Leroy always gives it all, always gives his whole heart to what he's doing. Oh, there you go.
Right on the gummies.
Oh, Gen is that, 1.
Is that a PlayStation?
That's a PlayStation.
It seems apt for Big Game Leroy, right? Oh.
Shot to the gut. Oh, the dish drive is open, Darnell. Oh, the open dish drive of the PlayStation. Big Game Leroy DDTs the king of the mecha.
Oh, but look at Alex. Instinctively roll out of the ring. Don't forget, this is one fall.
Oh. LPP. Sneaking up behind on BGL at the perfect moment. Much like his name says. But guess who? It's Delightful Dan! Oh. Trying for the Twix of Fate. Blocked. Oh! Oh my goodness, he can pick him up! Oh! Big slam, LPP! Two! And that's
it! Oh my God. What a match.
Holy crow, Darnell. That was Mecha Mayhem.
Are you okay, Alex? They took your pizza. I don't.
Well, the oppositions on this evening are victorious at Showa Bunga 2, Mecha Mayhem, LPP, Ryan Mooney, Alex Ryman, Aaron Ash, and of course the King of Chaos. Oh, this is great. Just sweeping out the trash. I guess this is what this is. I'm sure you like this type of stuff, Darnell.
I mean, look, they won it. It's fair and square. I mean, what a match. What a way to utilize these things. What a way to utilize these weapons. What a way to utilize the fans. In a way, it's unbelievable.
While there's a break in the action, I want to give a special shout out to all of our sponsors who have made Wrestlers Lab Showa Bunga 2 totally rad. First off, over on Twitter, Fight Boys with a Z. Then folks over on Instagram, JCP Designs, Medina Art Media, Smarknado, Mesa Media, which you could find at SMesa85, and all of our friends over at the TMNT Universe, you could find them at UTromsX. Thanks, everybody.
I have looked all over this entire venue and still haven't found this belt, Weber. I'm telling you.
Yeah, it's
Irving and Andy have it.
It's not back here.
Then where else is it gonna be but with the creeps, Weber?
Yeah, we gotta go out soon.
I know!
Okay,
I'm not excited about
this! How can we
pretend
this? Can we both fit in this belt?
Can we both fit in the belt? Okay, they'll never know.
Alright,
They'll never know it's missing. They'll never...
Okay, we're going out like...
Perfect. I'm fine. Let's go! Creep!
I'm getting my belt back!
Full Sheridan Building, welcome back. This is the second half of Wrestlers Lab Presents Showa Bunga 2, Mecha Mayhem. Now, this first match will be a championship match and will be for the Wrestlers Lab Collaborative Championship. This match is scheduled for one fall.
And here we are back at it. I'm Toddy Tondera. And I'm with Darnell Mitchell for the second half of Wrestlers Lab Showa Bunga 2. And we're going to start things out collaborative. Here comes the trash gaze.
It looks like there maybe might be smuggling something underneath those robes.
Yeah. You saw what they did.
You know, all's fair in, you know, the game of war. So
for those who haven't been apt to social media in this collaborative championship match. It will be the outfielders versus Creeps, and Creeps took one of their titles. It's a hostage, Darnell. It's a hostage.
It's a hostage, but at least they only took one title. That's, you know, that's giving in itself, I feel.
And their opponents.
There's no duplicating the infectious energy that the outfielders bring not only to Wrestler's Lab, but professional wrestling. Here comes the collaborative champs. It looks like they're going to be sharing that one title.
See, really, really what the Creeps are doing is they're just getting them closer together. I mean, they've been wrestling together for years since the beginning of their careers, but, you know, they're just trying to bring them together. It's actually very nice what they're doing.
The outfielder said they work so hard to get these titles, there's just no way they are letting them go anytime soon. Now, physically, they've been let go, but they are the collaborative champions, no matter who physically carries both titles. But look at that. Shea got their belt back. I don't think Shea wants to even give it up to Wrestle.
Yeah.
It's been out of their possession now for a little while. They said, simply put, the Creeps can't have them. The Creeps can't have them. If this is your first time seeing Creeps, they can't really exist either politically or socially. And this, they are also making their Mecca debut. They were at Big Gay Brunch 8 in Tampa versus my friends in the Runway.
This is very exciting to finally see the Creeps. I've been following them online for years. I've seen so many clips. I've seen so many matches. Next for them to grace us with their presence here in Ritual Park, New Jersey.
Yeah, the Creeps definitely seem more up your alley, especially with their behavior. Stealing everything. Stealing titles. You have to win titles. You can't steal them.
But see, what they've done, though, is at least they've gotten to their head. Maybe they can pull out the big one here today. The first of two title matches here tonight for Wrestler's Lab Show Bungle 2.
I'd like to welcome both teams to this match for the Wrestler's Lab Collaborative Championship. Introducing first the challengers. They are sponsored by at Jay-Z Beastie. Fighting out of New Orleans. First, we are known far and wide as KJ Styles.
That's right.
Here is Owen Watts. They are the incredible Funny Hulk. And ultimately, they can't really exist either politically or socially. Here are the Creeps.
Andy, the muscle parent, in there with Irv.
They are sponsored by At Joyful Violence.
Yeah.
Fighting out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Trying to steal again.
He is very, very, very bad for you. Shane McCoy, together, they are the outfielders.
And here we go, Darnell. What an experiment we have on our hands. Some of the best tag team wrestling in independent wrestling is Wrestler's Lab. What a showcase here for Showa Bunga 2.
And how amazing is it that our champions are actually the outfielders? I mean, keep in mind, they held the Camp Frog Tag Team Championships for 700 plus days. They're one of the best tag teams out there.
700 plus days, huh?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
That's quick math.
Yeah. Rosie Jones in there holding up those collaborative title belts, which, as you can see, Creeps are just trying to take. You got to earn something like that. You just can't take it and make it yours. I know they can't exist politically or socially, but they could at least wrestle. Those are heavy belts. They're over by us now. the outfielders win, maybe we could get a picture with them with those belts. We're tag team champs, too.
Yeah, maybe we should steal the belts, actually.
Andy starting in there with Shea. Locking up there in the center of the ring. Headlock.
Oh,
twisting the arm back around. The muscle parent.
Yeah, you can't give Andy any room.
Oh, breaking through there is Shea. Andy does have some muscles on them. I definitely wouldn't want to be in there against Andy. Or really, the creeps in general. They creep me out. Funny as I say that, huh? Oh, headlock again.
They're a specimen in their own right.
Grinding that in.
Do not want to be in a headlock. You do not want to go one-on-one in terms of strength with them.
Back across here. Obviously, the Labradors here at the Mecca firmly behind the outfielders. The outfielders kind of have a scrappy style, a never-say-die attitude.
They throw all caution to the wind.
I think it's like it's almost like if Bruce Springsteen was just a cutie, that would be the outfielders. Well, Bruce Springsteen is, but he's more handsome.
Exactly.
Yeah. Twisting the arm of Shea McCoy is Andy Ripley. Coming back around here. Oh. Waist control. Oh, duck out of the way.
Very, very, very smart by Shea.
Can't get around them. Oh, leapfrog over. Oh, drop kick to the knees. Chop down. Oh. High-end kicks here. Oh! 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 Faked me out too, Darnell. Oh, big clothesline.
It's amazing. Big smile. Oh, go for the pinfall.
Two! Oh, just a two count.
Still a big smile on the face of Shea McCoy.
The last time we saw the outfielders, of course, they defeated the rep to become collaborative champions at 7 years of science. And a big bonk for Andy Ripley. Irv is not having this. Irv is now in the ring. Rosie, you got to clear Irv out. Oh! What is going to... You want to talk about collaborative?
Oh! Not just known for his quickness.
Sheesh!
Best move in wrestling.
Is this the first time you're watching professional wrestling? That's the best move there is. And a cut with the throat here. One. Oh, just a one count. Just a one count. Now, creeps are a bit of scavengers. They call themselves trash gays. And they're scavenging around in this match, too. Oh, back into individual corners. Usually, Weber has more of a Lucha Libre style, but again, pulling out the stops here. Oh, flipping over here. Oh, forearm shot. Duck under. Oh, spearing Irv. Oh, almost landing on his feet. Turns into a Hurricane Rana. Way to be. Has Irv's arm a little slapped to the chest here. There we go. That's what we know from Weber. Flipping around town, and here we go. It's the outfielders.
Keeping up the pace. Weber's just incredible to watch in the ring. That's why they have the fan support, of course.
Oh, big elbow. Big elbow down. Oh. Repeated elbows. Gotta get the air right out of her. What do you think, Darnell?
I actually don't even know how Weber's still doing this.
That's a good point. I don't know how Irv is surviving or how Weber is doing this. Either way, Weber's in some incredible shape, obviously.
Ooh. Yep, and there's a big dip.
Oh, just a one there, maybe taking a little bit too much time. Outfielders here working on Irving West.
I don't know if I mentioned it. Oh, yes, I did, but I'll mention it again. They were fresh off a big gay brunch in Tampa. Choking. Oh! There's some collaborative moves, but it's kind of on the sketchy side, Darnell.
I mean, they're in the corner. They're holding the tag team ropes. I don't really understand what's exactly sketchy about that, but, you know.
It's a championship match. This is Wrestler's Lab. Got to behave better than that.
Well, their objective is clearly to win the match, to be the champion.
Well, look at Andy Ripley coming around here. They come around. They're pulling Shea off the apron. It is left Irv up there with Weber.
They just want to show us their outfit. Like, I don't understand. Your animosity towards the creeps.
Yeah, fair. But, I mean, you would know a thing or two about showing off an outfit, I suppose.
Absolutely.
So right now, the challengers, creeps, taking it to Weber Hatfield. Shea down here on the outside, trying to get their bearings around them. Pulling the hair. Oh, you don't want to be in unfamiliar territories here. Like Weber Hatfield is.
And it's one of the smartest things that a tag team can do. Cut off the ring. Keep them in your corner. Keep the pace up. Keep the match momentum to what you want it to be. And the creeps are showing why they're one of the best tag teams out here.
Gut blows.
Just nonchalant.
Creeps have been waiting for this exact moment. They like to work from on top, as they say. And right now they have full control of this match. There we go. There's that crowd for the outfielders. Holding on to the neck of Weber. Shot to the gut for Irv. Oh, big overhand forearm.
Yeah, Shea's got to get the tag in.
Oh, Shea trying to reach in for any momentum, and there we go. Helps out Weber a little bit. Slaps to the chest. Headbutt. And here we go. Duck under. Oh, here we go. It's going to tag in. Kind of cut off a bit. Grabbing onto the leg. Yeah, Rosie, get Andy out of there. There we go. Oh. And then Weber makes the tag into Shea. And Shea is going to come fresh in here. Oh, slap. Oh, Shea working one on two. Oh, beating down Andy is Shea.
Shea's on fire. Wait, the ref didn't see the tag. I mean, I was cleaning my glasses. I didn't see the tag either.
There was a tag. Darnell, there was a tag. We saw it. Is that what Rosie's saying?
There's no interim. I think that's what's happening right now. The ref didn't see it. I mean, we got to follow the ref's rules. That's just all we're doing.
Rosie's
got to
turn around. Look behind your back, Rosie.
I just see Irvin standing there. He looks great.
Creeps choking out the life of Weber. Shea McCoy making that tag. Rosie Jones did not identify that tag, so Shea is kicked back out, so Weber has to work from the ground up again.
Excellent for him. Nothing pretty about that. Just knocked you to the ground.
Choking on the neck of Irv. Oh.
Shea trying to get that crowd support.
But as you can see, Darnell, Creeps keeping Weber in that corner. Weber has been in that corner for the last at least a couple of minutes.
And once again, one of the best things about tag team wrestling, just being smart.
Back into the turnbuckle again. Oh, flips over.
Oh,
look at that. Sunset flip of sorts. Oh, just a two count. Reaching up here. Andy trying to go for the tag. Weber reaching up, but I don't think Weber has enough strength.
I don't think Weber even realized how close he was.
There we go, Enziguri! Did that internal momentum drive Weber to his tag team partner, to Shea McCoy, and here comes Shea. The champs bring in a fresh competitor in Shea McCoy, and they are livid. Oh, headbutt. Headbutt.
Shea's been out of the match for quite some time. Got nothing but energy.
Oh! One runaway train, never coming back.
Oh.
Cannonball into the corner. Oh! fire away Shea McCoy of the Outfielders, holding their team up. Belly to belly! Here's the cover! Two! Oh, just a two count.
Shea showing once again why they are the tag team champions, with Weber keeping on Irvin.
I think they grabbed him up by the ears. Oh, scratch to the eyes. And the Boo Birds are really going to come out if Creeps keep acting like this. Ooh, forearm through. Head butt. Here comes the muscle parent back in. Oh, duck under. Behind that.
Prettier.
Doesn't get less pretty than that, but in comes Weber Hatfield. The collaborative champions are on top right now. And speaking of on top, Weber is on the top rope here. Not sure if the Creeps see that. Here comes Irv around. Front shotgun drop kick.
Weber working purely off of adrenaline here. He's taking a beating in this match.
To the center. Oh, by that hair. Hate when people pull my hair, honestly.
Oh, just spiked him.
Right on the top of the head, Darnell, with that DDT. And now, dead weight. Just simply dead weight at this point.
You could see that. Oh.
One, two, and oh! I thought we might have new champs.
I thought so, too. You could see Weber trying to twist himself in midair to try to take less of that damage.
Oh, into the turnbuckle there. Pulling Weber up to the top turnbuckle. Working each. So Weber's up there. Uh-oh, here comes Shea. What a precarious position that Andy puts themselves in. Oh, big power bomb! Shea waking up Weber, who's sitting on the top rope trying to motivate their tag team partner. And motivated is Ever. I think that was a version of a Meteora. Two. Oh, just a two count.
Just a two count. Not only a kick out, but you can see that Irvin actually went in there too, also to help his tag team partner. Very, 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 very smart wrestling there.
Nobody's standing right now, Darnell. They're all trying to get to their feet.
I think they're all trying to ask themselves, what do I need to do to win this match?
Okay, it looks like they have something up their sleeve. It looks like this has maybe been pre-plotted here.
Yeah, Irvin directing traffic.
So I think Andy is tagged back in. Oh, working that arm, wrenching that arm. Oh, spin kick! Taking it a little bit too much time, Darnell. Oh! Kick to the stomach here. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, back of the head against the ropes. Double cover. Two. Oh. And sometimes sloppy is all you need.
Hey, if it gets the pinfall.
Like this, it doesn't have to be pretty, is what I was trying to say before. It's just got to get the job done. And the bad blood between these two, I'm sure Shea and Weber are glad to be holding those collaborative championships here at Wrestler's Lab. Yes. Who is next for the Outfielders, Darnell? I certainly don't know.
I certainly don't know either, but that was an impressive win right there. You could see how at the end it seemed like Irvin hit his head on the bottom, and they had the wits to both pin. That's the reason why they're champions. But an impressive showing here by the Creeps. Very nice to see them.
Can't be hiding any title belts under any bathrobes, Ka.
And they get candy out of it. It's amazing.
Wherever the Candyman Delightful Dan goes, there's just candy just follows him. So I'm sure if we looked around, we could get a few lollies. The outfielders victorious. Proud Wrestlers Lab champions. We've still got more to go, so if you're watching in the future on YouTube, thank you again. Leave some comments for us to see, but the outfielder is victorious so far.
Welcome back, referee Gina Monti. Now, we also want to tell you about our sponsor, of somebody that's very special. He's bashful and he hates that I do this. But he is sponsored by Mesa Media, the only Florida production company specializing in shooting and editing wrestling flicks and mixtapes. This man back there, the gift guy, Hokai.
Very cool. Very cool.
The man.
And he makes everyone look better, and he gives us all a form. Thank you so much, the gift guy, Hokai, for all your hard work.
I wish I was the god of something.
You have amazing hair.
One of the sponsors who, for Black History Month, prepared a graphic featuring some of the greatest black talent, many of which are featured on tonight's show. Thank you, Brian F. Bell, for all you do for the wrestling community.
Heck yeah.
And you know what, Chad? I know as an Italian, we all complain during an Italian Heritage Month, hey, well, where's our poster? Brian F. Pro made us one too when we were too lazy ourselves to make one. So Brian F. Pro, thank you for celebrating everyone in professional wrestling.
Maybe when they do commentators, maybe we're shooting for that.
Yeah, absolutely. Brian.
With that said, this next match is a singles match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first,
oh, so this is why there was a body bag in the locker room. I didn't know this fella was here.
If you haven't seen him wrestle before, you're in for a treat.
Calculated, unpredictable.
Legend. You can't talk about Wrestlers Lab without talking about Grimm. The first ever Wrestlers Lab champion.
Held that for a long, long time. And he said, out of my cold, dead hands. And I've seen Mr. Grimm, for his size, do things that I haven't seen smaller people do. Mr. Grimm, 450 splash over on Brohemoth and Enjoy Wrestling was crazy.
And his opponent,
and making his Wrestlers Lab debut all the way from Atlanta, Georgia.
He is sponsored by at Sky underscore Create Plus. Fighting out of Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 241 pounds, but
and when wrestlers yell like that, you know they're ready. The Killa, the MF and Riffer, trained by Suge D and QT Marshall over the past months, an incredible body transformation for Trey Shaw.
Yeah, Trey Shaw's here to make a point. Trey Shaw's here to represent Atlanta, and I've just got to point this out, but free Palestine.
This may be the hardest hitting match on the card this evening. I know when you deal with Mr. Grimm, somebody is going to get murked. An eerie silence in the ring as Mr. Grimm and they often call Mr. Grimm the litmus test of the lab. As you mentioned before, Darnell, an OG of Wrestler's Lab, the first champion. At 7 years of science, he fought Ashton Starr down there in Pittsburgh. Wrestling's hitman for hire. And that's no joke.
Absolutely. When you say he's a litmus test, you say that because when you want to come into Wrestler's Lab, you want to fight the best. You want to wrestle against the best. And who better than the first ever champion?
Test of strength in the ring right now. The MFing Ripper. And wouldn't that be something if Trayshaw is able to get a victory here over Mr. Grimm? I mean, that would be the biggest, maybe the biggest upset of the night?
Absolutely, an impressive debut.
I think Mr. Grimm is checking out his opponent, letting his opponent be a little cocky here, see what he has in store, kind of.
You pointed out something earlier. Ripper's got to be very, very clear about what his game plan is here tonight. Because, yes, Mr. Grimm will punch you, he'll beat you down to the ground, but in a heartbeat, he'll be on that top rope. In a heartbeat, he's one of the most athletic big men in the business.
Yeah, he's likely to cave in the Mecca. All checking Ref Gene in there, checking if the shoulders are down. Just a two count. Grinding in the head there. Grinding, I think, a headlock. Oh, flipping around. Oh, kind of teaching Trayshaw a little bit of the ropes there, huh? Of how you can succeed in Wrestler's Lab. Oh, headlock there again.
Look how tight that is. Mr. Grimm keeping the pressure on.
Yeah, his strength is probably unmatched. Oh! Wow, I'm surprised that Trayshaw stood up. He's still standing in there.
I'm surprised the ring stood up.
I think Trayshaw's like, let's do it, dude. Two Rams bucking heads here at Showa Bunga 2 for Wrestler's Lab. Oh.
Their own sort of version of test of strength here. They're still feeling each other out this early in the matchup. That kick to the chin is going to knock anybody back just a little bit.
Oh, this is going to get pretty rough, I think. These two are going to start batting each other's heads. Oh. Caught him there. Oh. Mr. Grimm was hoping that could trick him, but just... Oh.
And there goes that athleticism that you were talking about earlier. Just with the quickness, he knocked that out. How many guys do you see do that?
Oh. And there's that next gear. When Grimm is in this next gear, I fear literally everyone. Everyone.
Complete disregard for his safety. Just throwing him over. Where he lands is where he lands.
Cover here. Two. Oh, just a two count. Kicking out there at two. Slap. Exchanging blows, and of course.
Oh. Nice counter there by Ripper.
Duck under. Oh, back, I believe, on his head. Goodness. And here comes the cover. Trayshaw. Oh, on the ropes. And again, if you are watching, still to come, our Wrestler's Lab Championship on the line. Eel O'Neill defending the title against Trevor Aeon a little later on in the show. Of course, Trevor Aeon, who we will see, won a 14-person battle royal at 7 years of science for his opportunity at Eel tonight. So speaking about opportunities, Trayshaw still trying to work on Mr. Grimm.
Look at the way that Grimm keeps his hands on him. He keeps him nearby to continue to inflict punishment.
Oh! My God. I didn't think he was going to get him up. I didn't think he was going to get him up, and he did. 2-0. Just a two count.
And that was just an instinct for him to kick out of it. That wasn't too much strength to kick out of that. I think Mr. Grimm is just really surprised by what Trey's bringing.
I guess that's why they call him the MFN Ripper. I almost said it.
It's a kid show. It's a kid
show. Family only. Oh, caught on the rope there. Oh, block. Oh, front forearm. Oh, tripped. Never seen that from Grimm before. Watch out, front row.
Yeah.
And that's why sometimes a safer place to put a body is in a body bag for Mr. Grimm, because if not, they're going to be flying all over the place.
That move allows Grimm to catch his breath here just a little bit.
As the sun sets, it gets a little bit more gloomy in here, and what a way for this Mr. Grimm match to continue.
Oh! Couldn't see it, but I could hear it.
I don't think we need to see it. Oh, punch to the gut. Grimm slowing the pace down, really inflicting as much pain in as possible.
And this is what you don't want. You don't want Grimm to work at his own pace.
Oh, here we go. Is that next gear again? Oh, it's like a switch that gets hit. And as soon as that switch gets hit, it stops making sense for everyone besides Grimm. He just sees red.
And you saw the focus there when he had him on the ring pulse. It was to the small of the back. Everything you do, you get your strength from the small of the back. Very, very methodical there by Grimm.
Grimm's sliding in there to break the count. I think referee Gino was a little lenient on that 10 count. Everybody wants to see a winner. We have our own experiments here. And show a bunga too. Crowd, I think, getting behind Trey, or at least attempting to, and that helps Trey out there. Oh, spear through. Oh, knee to the gut.
Trey's got to keep it. Oh, what? Oh. What's he planning here?
Oh, Darnell, what is this? To the small of the back of Mr. Grimm. And this is what Wrestling Lab offers. Wrestlers Lab offers every time we put on a show. In the ring comes Trey Shaw with the cover. Two. Oh, just a two count. Just a two count still. What is it going to take? And I'll be honest, I think Trey Shaw is putting up a much bigger fight than I thought was coming.
I think he's getting the fans. Fans are really starting to understand what he came here to do. Fans are really starting to understand why he is such an impact.
Trey to his feet. See what he has in mind. Grimm on his back, which you honestly
don't see much.
Yeah. I don't know if this is wise, waiting for Grimm to get back up for Trey Shaw. I don't know that I would wait on that. Oh, hooking him up, I think. Oh, they're jockeying for position. They're jockeying for position here. Oh, finally got some of it. Oh, didn't get enough. I mean, just the pure weight of Mr. Grimm.
The pure weight and how?
I almost grabbed you. Fierce competition here at Wrestler's Lab. Showa Bunga 2.
I don't think Grimm was prepared for any of this. Surprised that Shaw didn't go for the pin right there.
Yeah. Oh, I think Trey said it's over. Does Trey have in mind here? Grimm slowly getting up. Again, I don't know that I would let Grimm get up. Oh, caught him flipping around. Oh, goodness.
What? It's like a machine.
deadlifting Trey Shaw up and on the back of his head, exchanging tit for tat.
You're right. It's like a switch. It's like a switch.
You could feel it. You could feel it. Oh. Oh, well, you could feel that. I don't care who you are.
That veteran move to roll out of the ring to ensure that Trey's not able to get any pressure on a pinfall.
Trey in there. I mean, maybe Trey is trying to win this by count. A win is a win, especially over Mr. Grimm, the first champion of Wrestlers Lab.
I agree. A win is a win. Whatever you can do to get the win, that's all that matters.
And a count to 10 will award Trey Shaw the victory here if Grimm doesn't get back in. And, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong, Darnell.
Trey's here to prove a point, I see. Doesn't want to win that way.
I was going to say, a win is a win over Mr. Grimm, but Trey Shaw said, no, I know this was going to be maybe my hardest hitting match that I've been in, and I want to give it to Mr. Grimm. I want to get a pinfall.
Yeah. My question is, was that the smart move? You're allowing Grimm to get back in the ring.
I don't think so.
And he knows how to capitalize as much as humanly possible.
But it does show the courage behind Trey Shaw.
Absolutely. Trey taking his time to get Grimm up.
Well, I think
it's a big boy.
Yeah, it's mostly dead weight. Ugh. Rolling big Mr. Grimm into the ring. Trey is just, I mean, wind's taken out of him just from lifting up Grimm.
The wind's taken out of me just watching this match.
Yeah.
So I can't imagine how he feels in that ring.
Oh, picking up Mr. Grimm here.
And there you go.
Oh, I think that was a bit of a setup by the Hitman for Hire, but up. Oh, against that top turnbuckle again. Oh, ducking out of the way.
Oh, big body splash.
Body on body. The litmus test of the lab. Why? He is calling that.
Incredible.
The Hitman for Hire. Agile as they come for as big as he is.
Every single time I see him wrestle, something new from Grimm.
So I said, somebody's always going to get marked when you deal with Mr. Grimm.
Is he going to go to die for the outside?
Let him talk to you. I thought Grimm was going to go through the floor. He was 3 feet over the top rope. In the cover here, this got to be it. Two and three.
Oh. Little lackadaisical with that pin there. Could have put more pressure on Trey because Trey is not giving up that easily.
I thought Trey was out of here. I think that's what Grimm thought too. Oh, up on the shoulders. Oh, and down. Signifying this could be the end. What does Grimm have in store next? Oh, out of the way. Oh, Trey Shaw kicked to the back. Duck under again. Oh, down to the canvas, that power in a big senton, and here's the cover. Two.
Oh, I thought that was in.
Two count.
What a match.
So it looks like that one of these two competitors are going to have to bring out something we haven't seen before. Referee Gina putting on the gloves, which usually signifies some type of physical impairment from one of the wrestlers.
Oh!
I don't know if anybody's got a bloody nose or a bloody lip, but a bloody something. Oh, no. On the torture rack. Up and... Oh! Down! Oh! Well, I'll tell you what. Oh, there's more. There's more. And for dinner, Death Valley Driver. Two! And you can ring them up.
Here is your winner, the Hitman for Hire, Mr. Grimm.
Mr. Grimm pulling out all the stops. Just the physicality of that match was crazy, Darnell.
And it was insane, and literally all the stops. Did you see that flurry of moves he had to do at the end of that match to get the 1-2-3? Mr. Grimm definitely obviously came out the victor here, but I think he has a newfound respect for Trey.
Referee Gina in there surveying the bodies. And that was billed to knock a hole in the Mecca. That was billed to be a hard-hitting contest. And I think we got what we had coming.
Grimm's getting tripped up.
Oh, I don't know.
This could go one of two different ways. Crowd showing their support to both of them, and honestly, they both deserve it.
Hopefully we get one of those chances at the end of the night, you and I.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
At handshake extended, Trey Shaw has passed the litmus test. Not good enough to win a victory this evening, but...
Definitely made a name for himself. For the future at Wrestler's Lab.
And we got two more still.
Two more incredible matches still, including the championship match with Eel and Trevor later on.
Well, we have a second. Who you have in that, Eel or Trevor?
You know, Trevor has been really impressive the past couple of years. He's gone through his own physical transformation. But I got to give it to the reigning champion, Eel. Eel has been on a roll. Eel, when he's in that ring, is so focused. I think Trevor's going to put it to him, but I think Eel's coming out with that victor.
Big Daddy, Adriana Mosley, I know that Billy Dixon has really been a splinter on your side the past couple weeks. What are your emotions going into this match?
It's not really any emotions involved, it's just business. But Daddy always means business. But as far as Billy, Billy's like a piece of pizza. He's easy to eat. Now, Billy, you already had the audacity to talk so much crap in your poor excuse of a promo. Really professional, by the way. 5 stars. But what got me was you said, let me make wrestling fuck again. So clearly, you have a problem getting laid. Big Daddy doesn't have that problem. So if you want to get fucked today, that's perfectly okay. That's all you had to do. All you had to do was ask. So today, Billy, you want to be the bottom? I told you I'd make you my bottom, bitch.
Well, it sounds like that match is going to...
We've got two big matches left for you, the first of which is a singles match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first,
this one's going to get pretty personal, I hear.
They've been going back and forth on social media. And it's the one and only.
Billy
the Gatekeeper. Now, being the center of attention in independent wrestling, will he be caught off guard this evening?
Well, his opponent is relatively new to wrestling, but Billy's been here for quite some time. The current reigning Uncanny Attractions champion,
the
Billy
unchampion.
Has done it on.
The unchampion, as they say. Big Daddy's in the house.
Adriana has made quite a little stir on social media. I mean, look at her. She's here to take it to Billy Dixon. And I wonder if Billy has been underestimating her.
Well, you know, he doesn't have a great track record against dominant women, so.
Wrestlers Lab. Okay, I know it's a Sunday evening. Wrestlers Live! Okay, so this is my first time here. And there's like this like beaker thing, science. And like I noticed that there's like people here. Who likes like anime?
It's a beaker.
Who likes like cartoons? How many of you cosplay? I am so sorry to say that none of you are cool.
Well, tell me something I don't already know, Billy.
Okay, I don't know if you are new here, but this is pro wrestling. We do things like drink beer, and we have affairs, and we tune in our spouses. Yours.
Oh. Darnell, what do you think about this crusade against nerd culture and wrestling that Billy Dixon is on?
As a nerd myself, I'm not 100% with it, but Billy Dixon at the end of the day can back up everything he's saying. Again, Billy has been around for years and years. Billy has been in every single promotion. Not here to make friends, just like a lot of other people here today. Here to win.
You know, Billy Dixon is preparing for GCW's For the Culture against Darius Carter, who we saw before by surprise. Doesn't seem like the Big Daddy's scared.
I think Billy's doing everything he can to get inside her head.
Decided.
Crowd seems pretty clear about who they're supporting here.
Oh!
The disrespect.
Oh, here we go. I don't know that we heard a bell, but we are off and running. Oh, big slap of the chest there. Maybe we did hear a bell. It's been crazy all day. Welcome to Mecha Mayhem, Wrestler's Lab. Showabunga 2, if you're just joining, got a heck of a contest going on in the ring. I'm Toddy Tondera.
I'm Jarno Mitchell, and Adriana with the big splash to Billy.
Ooh.
I don't think Billy was expecting this. Leg sweep.
Uh-oh.
Oh! That's a lot of butt coming to you.
Talk about a drive-by. Big Daddy rolling Billy towards the center of the ring, and here's the cover. Rosie Jones down two. Oh, just a two count. Up against that. Oh! Yeah, Billy Dixon, over the course of, what, 4, 5, 6 years, has been running the independents. Now here in Wrestler's Lab. Oh, choking down, shoulders down, too. Just a two count.
Billy rolling to the outside. Not only just a veteran move, but Billy rolling to the outside, I think, to refigure out his plan. I don't think he was expecting all that aggression so quickly. But well, do not give Billy the time to think. He will always have a plan, and he can work quick as hell.
It's a great point there, Darnell. Big Daddy following Billy Dixon down. Oh, there you go. Like you said, give Billy Dixon a bit too time to think, and he'll figure out ways. That's why they call him the gatekeeper. And I'm sure this is a part of the Billy Live 2024 tour.
The Billy Delphia tour?
Ooh, I like that.
Oh,
that's why you make the big bucks, Darnell. Oh, down. Face first. The anime aficionado, gamer, cosplaying society that Billy is against is exactly what Adriana is.
And that's one of the best things also about Billy. Ooh. Like, Billy's going to bring it to you in the ring, but Billy's also going to talk to you in the ring. Billy's going to make sure you know what he feels about you.
Master manipulator, as they say.
Absolutely.
Oh, I guess over to our side now. Billy looking to punish Big Daddy in front of all of us. Snapmare over. Oh. Kick to the shoulder blade. Oh, pump kick. Big splash. Two. Oh, just a two count. You know, coming into this match, Darnell, the talk was, could 2024 become the year of Daddy? And I think the fans, the Labradors here at the Mecca, think so.
Yeah, Billy's been running things for quite some time. He's looking to keep that momentum going into 2024, of course, on the tour. But Adriana's doing everything in her power to stop it. Look, oh,
shot. I think Adriana was trying for a suplex there, pushed off back against the ropes. Oh, big clothesline. Oh, just leaning back here. Two and no, just a two count. Just a two count here.
Billy did not think he was going to win on that pin. That was just to show her who he is.
I think you're right. Of course, you could check out Billy Dixon on March 9th at the Enjoy Odyssey. Billy Dixon's been all around. Oh, look at this. Labradors here aren't too happy about this one. Oh. Slaps across the chest. And I think you would agree, Darnell, speaking about science, Billy Dixon is a scientist in the squared circle, whether it be promoting, whether it be wrestling. Just as an individual, brings a lot to professional wrestling, but also isn't too nice. That's the ebb and flow of Billy Dixon.
It is the ebb and flow, but at the end of the day, Billy Dixon, his major thing is to make sure that you know who he is, and you cannot be a fan of professional wrestling without knowing who Billy Dixon is.
That's fair. We certainly do. It's grinding down there on Big Daddy. Up, slipping out of it, it looks like. Oh! Kick to the chest. Oh, waiting a little too long, I think. For Billy to get up, and Big Daddy Adriana attacking. Bounce against the ropes. Oh, big clothesline down. Quick cover here. Could this be it? Upset in the works. No. Just a two count.
I love how quick she ran over to get that pin. She's got to keep that pressure on Billy just like that.
People want Billy to tap here. She's really stretching Billy out here. Grinding down.
think of what a win against someone like Billy Dixon could do for Adriana.
Adriana's shoulders are down. And just like you don't know, I've seen Billy in a lot of brawls, dog collar matches, a lot of blood. Just went against Maid Kira at Big Gay Brunch. Bounce against the ropes is the center of attention.
Up and down.
Kind of an awkward cover there. Trying for something different is Adriana. Rolling Billy back in the centering.
Going for it again. Is that an STF I see there?
Yeah, I think so. Guess that is her plan to win this on the mat.
And the positioning is perfect right in the middle of the ring. Billy's got to exert a lot of energy to get out of this.
Be something if Big Daddy wins this. Two. Just a two count for Adriana. Back to their feet. Working through it. Big DDT.
Perfect DDT.
I think this could be it. Two and no. Just two so far. Just a two count.
You see the look on Billy's face. I think he's getting a little bit frustrated here. He's got to keep his eye on the prize.
You stupid bitch!
Oh, no.
Cutter! Here comes the cover. Two and... And we talked about that before. Billy does have questionable track record against dominant women, as you can see. He was trying to reign over Big Daddy, and that only fired up Adriana.
She has a game plan, and she's going for it. Another SCF attempt, again in the center of the ring.
Could this one be it here?
That is a long way to the ropes.
Twisting around here. Hand on the bottom rope, has 5 seconds to break. And unfortunately for Big Daddy, Adriana had to do it. Now we see some frustration from Big Daddy.
Adriana's got to be careful. She's got to keep her eyes on Billy here. Just put a little jewelry on.
Hey, Darnell, I don't think Rosie sees this. I don't think Rosie saw that. Sucker punch. Is this a two? Ring the bell. What the hell?
Billy Dixon tour continues with another win underneath his belt. But impressive showing here by Adriana, making her lab debut.
I don't really have much to say about that victory, except yes, Billy proves to be dominant this evening, and his run in independent wrestling continues victorious here at Wrestler's Lab.
Hey, even if you're winning by nefarious means, it's all good. It's human nature. Express yourself, don't repress yourself.
What a win regardless. And we have one more match, Darnell.
I can't wait for it.
We've been waiting for this for quite some time, since 7 years of science. Championship match next up here, but we're gonna do a little parading around still with Billy Dixon.
Billy's still getting it with the fans.
We're just gonna rip up all the Reese Rose signs, huh?
All right, everybody. We got a lot of questions. We want to thank you again. I love you. Broken Optics, Curtain Tricker, Fight Boys, Chasey P Designs, Sparknado, this is Peter, TMNT Universe, and Mesa Media. Now, it would be remiss, I tried to call out anybody that I see in the crowd, but we are in the presence of royalty. I must give my respects to Faye Jackson.
Fair. Jackson is here. What up?
She's mother.
A legend. One of the best ever, honestly.
Now, Laboratories, we want to thank you all for participating. You brought your weapons that were well used. You brought your voices. and that noise today, the speaker sitting with us, and we thank all of you for supporting the lab. But with that said, we have reached the main event of the evening, and this will be contested for the Wrestlers Laboratory Championship. This will be a singles match scheduled for one fall.
I got the jitters about this one, I gotta tell you. And Trevor Eon has been waiting for his champs at Eel O'Neill since he won a 14-person battle royal at 7 years of science. Winning that battle royal gave him this opportunity to once again face Eel O'Neill one-on-one for the Wrestlers Lab Championship. This will be Trevor's third attempt at Wrestler's Lab. Eel O'Neill has went on record to say if Trevor doesn't beat him, he will not allow another opportunity. So Trevor has got to beat Eel O'Neill, or he's out of luck, as they say.
There's a lot of pressure on Trevor today. Of course he wants to win the belt, but you're right. This is his third attempt of it. He's unfortunately lost against the likes of Envy Young and Grimm. He has a determination that I haven't seen in a long time from him. He is looking to win this title from Eel. This is going to be a barn burner.
The original gothic gangster, Hell King Supreme, has been with Wrestler's Lab since year two. So eager for that belt.
And his opponent.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me, really? They call him a bad brain for a reason. The submission super villain. Get that swagger.
That cockiness coming to the ring. I mean, he deserves it. He's been in Wrestler's Lab for quite some time. He's been the champion, winning it from Envy Young. You got to be a little bit of cocky when you're the champion fighting in this main event.
Sagittarius Rising. Wrestler's Lab, Mecha Mayhem, this is our champion. And as Darnell mentioned, champion, and what I saw, Eel O'Neill choking out Envy Young on the street for that championship belt. Last time we saw Eel was victorious over Erica Lee at 7 years of science.
To the main event of Wrestler's Lab, Showabunga 2, Mecha Mayhem. This bout will be contested for the Wrestler's Laboratory Championship. The woman in charge of the bell, referee Gina.
Go, Gina!
With that said, it's time to meet your challenger. Fighting out of the throne room of hell by way of ATL.
Devil.
He is sponsored by At Choice and Science, fighting out of Baltimore, Maryland, weighing 230 pounds. He's the reigning, defending Wrestler's Laboratory champion, the submission super villain.
Darnell, that was your pick for this evening for the champion to retain. And I'll tell you what, just for fun, I'm going to go with Trevor.
All right.
It's going to be a steep hill to climb.
Absolutely. But I gotta point something out for Trevor. Look at the way Trevor is not only looking at that belt, but looking at Eel. He's got his eyes on the prize.
Here we're about to get this going. The bell has rung, and this is your main event, Wrestlers Lab Showabunga 2 for the Wrestlers Lab Championship. Sounds of new champ around the room as Trevor Aeon. Oh, there he is from his perch.
Oh, my gosh. That speed is unmatched.
Usually when someone starts that quick, I say as a metaphor, it's like a bat out of hell, but he's literally a bat out of hell.
Complex.
Literally a bat out of hell.
Trevor, known for that quick Scioto suplex he calls a goplex.
Oh, I think he was going to maybe go for that kiss, kiss, bang, bang, that pump handle slam. We shall see, but in comes O'Neal, and then up. Oh, diving uppercut.
What an explosive beginning to this match. Again, determination. Trevor is here to win. Trevor, not saying that Neil isn't, but Trevor's got something in his eye. I swear to God, that guy is a demon. He is focused.
Hey, last chance, right, Darnell?
Last chance. You got to put your all into this.
Got to beat Eel this evening. It's actually, as you can see, Eel has put on muscle, has put on weight, has put on mass to be ready for this. Oh, begging for Trevor to stop. Trevor Aeon. Oh.
Trevor's got to be careful with that count.
Oh, breaking the count there.
Smart. Can't win the belt.
Oh! Now, one of the most interesting things about Eel O'Neal, and maybe you could speak on this a little, Darnell, he's very much about the rules. He is a pure wrestler. But he has said when he comes to situations like Wrestler's Lab, he always wanted to be a pure wrestler. But he doesn't really abide by the same rules that he preaches. It's almost like he's a bit of a hypocrite, no?
Does it really matter in the grand scheme of things? He's the next approach to a wrestling champion. He's a Wrestler's Lab champion. It doesn't really matter what you say. It matters what you do. And what he does do in that room is in that ring is he wins every single time.
And he has the belt, right? He has that championship. And here comes Eel, the Bad Brain on attack. Oh, my goodness. Look out below.
And keep in mind, yes, Eel is known for his submission matches, but Eel can do it all. A perfect person that is equally rounded out in all skills as a wrestler.
Two huge performers, two huge personalities is your main event of Showabunga 2 for that Wrestlers Lab Championship. And I think for a match like this, I think referee Gina is going to let the rules slide a little, which I do agree with. I do agree with. It is for that championship that sits on our desk right now.
You can see Eel's not too concerned with the... Oh, here comes the quick cover.
Ooh, just a one.
Eel's not too concerned with the count. He still will be champion if there's a count out.
Of course, Eel O'Neal is a big part of Flying V versus Super Art Fight down in Maryland. Wrestles all over the globe, part of Kings of the District. He's an Enjoy Wrestling regular. With that championship around his waist, he's defeated the likes of Erica Lee, Ziggy Haim, Boar. Oh! Dropped down again on the lower plexus of Trevor Aeon in the cover, just a one count again.
Eel's starting to get a little bit frustrated, but he can't let it get to his head. Trevor will take any opportunity he can.
Oh, front forearm there. Backing up a little bit. Head of steam ahead. Oh, spear into the midsection. You know, if you take the air out of your opponent's lungs, can't really do any high flying, can't do anything speed related.
Which is something Eel needs to do, because once Trevor's in the air, he's going around like crazy. Notice also each time Eel has done this, he allows the count to get all the way to four. He is utilizing, he's following the rules. But he is utilizing everything he can to his advantage.
He will bend those rules as soon as he can. There you are. Great example.
It's still a count. I have yet to see anything of the sort.
Heel taking his time, and I'll give you this, Darnell. It's a smart champion. It's a smart, smart person in that ring. Ooh. Shot to the gut there. Oh, there we go. Trevor coming back. Trevor's my pick. Bounce against the ropes. Oh! Cut off at the pass once again.
And that continued sort of pinpointing there for the stomach of Trevor.
Suplex coming up. Oh. Like a fisherman, but it's blocked. Uh-oh, small package. Two. Oh, just a two count. Coming right back up, and Eel catches him. Oh, that power. Wow.
That's simple, man. It's a body slam, but what a body slam that was.
Eel O'Neill, what a degenerate. Here's the cover. Just a one count so far. As I mentioned before, as soon as these two went eye to eye in Pittsburgh, we knew it was going to come to this. Showabunga 2, our main event. Darnell Mitchell here with Toddy Tondera. Thank you for joining us. Was that like a one-legged Boston Crab a little bit? Something of the sort?
Yeah, similar. It's just like the stronghold. That's the thing about Eel, too, is that Eel can beat you in a plethora of ways. Again, we already talked about his submission skills, but he's going to do everything in his power to tie you up like a pretzel, case in point.
Now, there is so much mystery to Eel O'Neill just scraping the surface of what he could possibly be. Keep in mind, he's still young. He's still collecting championships.
This is very effective by Eel. Interesting submission move here, but it makes it so that Trevor has to put more energy by keeping his shoulders off the mat.
Oh, row, row, row your boat. Kind of getting momentum here, and that's the only way out of that one, Darnell.
Right, just punch him in the face. Typically works.
Yeah. Down again. Again, we are at the Mecca. This is independent wrestling's home on the East Coast. Oh! Oh! Is that like a back elbow, back handspring type of vibe? Up on the shoulders. Oh, with ease!
Trevor, stay on him.
Oh! Eel says, I've been there. It's fine. Oh, just a two count. How explosive both of these two are.
Absolutely. Eel catching his breath here. I don't know if we want to give Trevor that time. Out of nowhere, Trevor would get a bunch of energy. Eel's got to be careful here.
Oh, that's one way to take the life out of you. Sleeper hold intact. Already got. Oh. Trevor ducking out of it. Eats a forearm. Does Eel O'Neill. Up. Oh. Big spine buster, it looked like there. In the cover. Two and. Ooh.
That was a beautiful cover.
We're getting closer. 2.7 there, maybe a 2.8.
Yeah, that's all he's got to keep that momentum. And Trevor's good at this, right? Once Trevor is in his zone, he is in his zone.
And his zone is pretty dark. Oh! Oh!
Big boss man would be proud there.
Two! Oh, just a two count. Hear him, Darnell, they're rooting for my guy. Wouldn't that be something? If this show ends with Trevor Aeon lifting that Wrestler's Lab championship above his head, but the bad brain looking to stop all of that. Up, oh, going again. Up. Oh.
To the top rope. What's he planning up here?
I do not know, but Trevor Aeon sat on the top rope. Eel climbing up to follow. Oh. Working away. Oh, attacking back is the midsection is Trevor.
Uh-oh. Oh.
The original gothic gangster with a powerbomb. Eel smart enough rolling on his back, getting up to his knees as fast as he can so he can't be covered. I don't even know if he knows where he is. Oh, it's proof positive he doesn't. Coming through here. Oh, snap Saito suplex. And I can feel the energy in the room shifting towards Trevor Aeon right now.
Look at that determination. Staring right through his soul.
If there's one person to do it, it's Trevor Aeon.
Looking to hopefully finish this.
Oh. Is he begging off? What in the world? This would... DQ.
I don't know what just happened there.
Oh! So per stipulation, Trevor had to defeat, pin, or submit Eel.
That matters is walking out with that belt. Eel O'Neil still your Wrestlers Lab champion.
The reign of the brain continues. And Trevor Aeon defeats Eel O'Neil. But what does this mean for the future of the Wrestlers Lab championship? Trevor was set to hopefully defeat Eel O'Neil and win that title, but by DQ, this might be Trevor's last chance no matter what.
Yeah, I don't know where Trevor goes from here. He looked incredible in the ring, but what is his future here at Wrestlers Lab?
Well, sound of applause. I guess I was right, Darnell. Trevor Aeon did win. Well, Darnell, we've had 9 incredible matchups today. Thank you for joining me. I appreciate this. I hope to see you back at the Mecca soon.
Absolutely. It was so nice to work with you. It was so nice to be here. Incredible night here. Thank you all for watching from home on YouTube. What a show.
And this has been Toddy Tondera. You get roached.